the thrill.
Doing it.
I would like to make some things clear. Okay? There we go. I ain't paying for this shit, chat. It's $60! I'm not paying for it! And I can't pirate it because I'd get in trouble. So... yeah! I ain't paying $60 for this shit, chat! There ain't no fucking way! That's way too much money! $60?! No! No, chat! It's not even worth that just to shit on it, chat! That's way too much fucking money! It's on Game Pass! Game Pass for what? Like, which Game Pass? You're paying $60, I ain't paying nothing! Oh my god. $60? Pippa, please be very controversial. Thanks. Well, I make no promises, Raphael. Okay. I want to explain. I never played any of the Saints Row games. I don't have, like, that innate attachment, I guess? I just really like the Saints Row 3 trailer. I just really fucking like the Saints Row 3 trailer. It's one of my favorite video game trailers of all time. Back when video game trailers used to be good. I want to show this to you guys. Because it made me want to play the game so bad. I just never ended up doing it. This trailer made me want to play the game so bad. This game looks like it has so much fucking style. This franchise looked like it had so much style. And looked like so much fun. I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. This trailer was phenomenal and so fucking good. I love it! It made it fun and hilarious. I used to watch some gameplay clips of it. I didn't really like watching it when I played it or whatever. It was like all fucking crazy weapons and shit you could do. Loud as hell, there we go. Is this not fucking cool, chat? Like, what the hell? Wow! I'm like... so far in the corner, there we go. It's stylish, it is! Such a fucking good trailer. Made me want to play the game so bad, chat. I need to go back and play them. Tanya was about to let you finish Pippa. I don't know. You know, Hulk Hogan was in this game as well? What? What? Hulk Hogan is in Saints Row? Play it? I need to. Two has a garbage PC port? Please play at least 2 and 3. Maybe we should play 2 and 3 as like... a fuck you to how terrible this new one looks. The new one... okay. Chat, the new one... wow, this came out like right after Skyrim, what the hell? I didn't even realize that. Didn't Skyrim come out on 11-11-11? I think it did. This came out like right after. Holy shit. For some reason, I feel like I remember this being older. I don't know why. That's probably why I didn't play this. I spent all my fucking money on Skyrim. Hi, Pippa. Pass me the chips and salsa. Okay, Jose. I think it was $2. It was quite the holiday season. This game is over 10 years old. 10 years old. Pre-order now, Pippa. Hell yeah. Okay, and I have not seen the official trailer for the new one, so we're going in this one blind. Imagine thinking with the $60, spending $60 on something. Couldn't be the... oh, I have it muted. Hold on, we gotta start over. I had it muted. Couldn't be me. SR3 is probably the only one worth your time, by the way, really? Ah, I have sniffles!
Eyes on the bar?
Yep.
Is it okay audio? I can... turn it up a bit. It feels quiet to me.
And I got the dealer. Nino, they're heading your way. They're here.
You should have eyes on the merchandise.
I sure do.
Immediately a downgrade.
Was that a gunshot?
Yeah, they shot the dealer.
Immediately a fucking so downgrade, Jack. Wow, so quirky. So quirky, Lamel. Whoa. Whoa, a guy just got shot and he said, that's so unprofessional. That's so quirky, Jack. Oh my god. They're like... millennials.
There's a lot of them. Can we do this?
We can't afford not to. Nina, you good?
Yeah, let's do it.
Great. Whenever you're ready, Kevin.
What are you guys thinking for dinner tonight?
How about my whole famous chili?
This guy looks like he'd be a fucking Fallout character.
Con carne.
In general, I kind of get Fallout vibes. I saw a lot of people. Not Fallout. Fuck. Not Fallout. Borderlands. Borderlands, not Fallout.
Hey, guys. What you got in the.
I've seen a lot of people comparing them, Borderlands and this game. And I really fucking see it.
My buddies and I have been looking all over town for this.
Fortnite looking? I don't know. I don't really know what Fortnite's aesthetic is, because I'm so used to seeing like, just like the anime crossovers?
You've been hoarding. See, we need him for our startup. It's a criminal empire, got it.
They're so quirky! They can't aim for shit! Wow! Bad guys, they got all these big guns and they can't just fucking shoot them! Just slow down! You're going too fast! Don't want to get a little bit too crazy there, fellas! Don't want to get a little bit too... Whoa! Okay, my limited understanding of the Saints Row franchise, right? My limited understanding of the... We're too close on her face. I feel like from what I've seen of the games, right? When the fucking motorcycle landed, it should have been like an explosion. It would have been so glorious. Very small detail. But just in general, right? Like, everything feels so like... I don't know, it feels like... boring. It feels so fucking boring. When it explode, goddammit, yeah! Is there someone made a twit longer into a game in Unity? Oh my god. No explosion, what the hell, man? There's no tension?
Dad, you should buckle up!
It's just not fun! This is not fun, chat. God, my sniffles! Would rather play the muscle guy? Yeah, the muscle guy is the only one that... Like, the muscle guy and the bike guy are the only two that look like they have any, like, interesting gameplay elements. Like, looking at this... Right? With the Saints Row 3 trailer, you could kind of get a feel for, like, who everyone was. A little bit, right? Like, there's the girl characters seem like they're kind of similar, right? They're like the brains of the operation type, possibly, right? There's the... Not this one. I think it's a different guy. That looks like he can, like, clone himself and shit. He's got a bunch of clones. This guy's, like, the strong character. Like, there's a bunch of different characters, right? Versus this one, there's three of the same exact fucking characters sitting in the car.
Get the fuck away from my friends.
Is that a girl box? Is that... Sorry, I distracted from her moment.
Hey! Asshole!
Get the fuck away from...
You better watch out, chat. She's got the side shape. She's gonna fuck you up. Hashtag slay.
From my friends.
Yes, queen! Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. A considerable downgrade, chat. hard on the Borderlands aesthetic, didn't they? They really fucking went for the Borderlands aesthetic. I don't know why. Like, why would you... Saints Row had such an iconic look. I don't know why you would... Why you would lose it. Why would you get rid of it? Pre-order it now? Oh, fuck no. Dad, don't pre-order games. Don't pre-order games. I say that as somebody who pre-orders games. Don't do it. Circle, thank you for $5. The main guy working on the PC patch for 2 unfortunately died, and Volition hasn't given an update on what's going on with it. Danny D, thank you for $5. One reviewer said Saints Row became predictable copy and paste. Cindy's Verkus, thank you for the $10. More proof the Marvel Cinematic Universe and its consequences have been a disaster for the human race. You know what? Yeah. Yeah, it has. Dangled Stalker, thank you for the 233. Whedon and his consequences have been a disaster for dialogue writing. Yeah! Yeah, fuck yeah, yes! Jesus Christ. And here's the story reveal trailer. Oh god, I keep fucking
moving. The world wants you to know. How do we make a statement?
Oh, it's a cat! Fuck, hold on.
The end power that the world wants you to know.
It's a cat. Cat. Millennials love cats.
How do we make a statement? We want to be more than a street gang.
We just got to be a little more creative.
Last time we got creative, people tried to kill us.
There's some quirky cat. See, like, that looked cool. That was pretty interesting, right? They got all the people in the bright ass pink suits and they're kind of funky looking.
You need to be your own boss.
It's our time now. Let's get this shit started.
Oh, so she's like a customizable character. She can be whatever you want her to be.
The boss of your job.
This company's nothing without me.
And the boss of your life.
There's no one I want more by my side than those guys.
Life is full of adversity and challenge.
God. We took on 2 crews at once and walked away just fine.
Guys, I was shot.
Your friends deserve better.
You really think you have
God,
what it
such
takes
borderline
to bring me
life.
You deserve better, but only you can choose to adapt to what life throws your way.
Grind said, baby.
You called for a ride?
Good call. Let's get that money.
Wow. The gangs look cooler. The gangs do look cooler.
And now it's time for us to reap the benefits.
A criminal empire.
I come for your crown.
Oh, God.
Yeah, don't try to figure it out.
Yeah, point taken.
We're really good
so quick
at what we do.
They're so quirky, Jack. God.
We call ourselves the Saints.
It looks like a fucking, like... Chad, doesn't it remind you of, like, those Sims movies people make? Have you guys seen that? People will, like, make entire movies in the fucking Sims. This is what the animations remind me of. The entire style or aesthetic of the game looks like a fucking Sims movie. Like, the animations are just stiff and floaty enough that they don't feel, I guess, intended to be there. Like, they're very, like, very general. You see what I mean? Hold on.
The Saints.
Like, look at that. Look at that!
We call ourselves the Saints.
They look like the Sims, chat! What the fuck do they have animating this shit? What the hell? I'm not normally somebody that like picks on the graphics and shit, but goddamn, like... It just... It's fucking boring, Jen. It's fucking boring and lifeless.
Only you can choose to adapt to what life throws your way.
Everything is... Like, what the fuck was that? There's no weight to anything, Chad!
You called for a ride?
Good call. Let's get that money.
Shit just happens!
We're starting
it's
a
so fucking
empire.
Terrible.
And now it's time for us to reap the benefits.
Jesus Christ. For Max Smiley, thank you for the $5. Remember when Sunset Overdrive had the LARPer faction joke, but did it better, or at least wasn't cringe about it?
Yeah, don't try to figure it out.
Yeah, point taken.
I don't know about that, man. Really, I don't know about that. Is that a faction in the game? Watch the original Saints Row trailer? Saints Row 1 trailer? Wow. Holy fuck, wow. Jesus Christ. This fucking... Saints Row!
Rated M for mature.
Oh, Sunset Overdrive is a better game! I've never played it.
I started out with nothing. Just a kid from the streets with nothing to lose.
Wow.
Then I met Julius, and everything changed.
Welcome to the Third Street Saints.
Once I joined the Third Street Saints, everything started going my way. I'd run some jobs, get paid, and Lady Luck was on my side. Now,
wow, better graphics!
Clothes, the rides, but it's not enough.
Jesus Christ, when did this come out?
I want it all.
Come on. Is this using? I feel like at least this is using like actual gameplay. At least this is using actual fucking gameplay with a trailer. That's something you don't see at all anymore. At least you know what you're fucking getting. 2006?
That's the great thing about this city. It's there for the taking. If you got what it takes.
God, that looks terrible.
Saints Row. Coming soon.
Saints Row. Coming soon. The fucking explosion chat is what I'm talking about! See, I've never even fucking seen this trailer before, chat, but I fucking just associate Saints Row with like over the top fucking looniness, violence. You don't see fucking any of that in here. You don't see any of that in here, chat.
Sure do.
Oh, crap, I don't want to watch all this again. It's just... shit just happened. Explosions are epic. Explosions are epic. It's silly, but you can tell there was soul. Man, that's a lot older than... a lot older, like, franchises, I guess. Like... I really like the older Borderlands, chat. I really like... I didn't like the new Borderlands, but... I think the older Borderlands had quite a bit of soul to them. Devil May Cry is incredibly over the top, and it's still amazing. It's just like... like, this is like the only semi-cool moment, and even then, it's just kind of like... it just feels squandered, right? Like, the fucking car driving backwards is like the highlight of this entire thing. And even then, it's like... man. Wouldn't it have been funnier if he had just gotten, like, squashed by that? Ah, no.
Kevin!
They're in zero danger? Yeah, all the quirky reactions and shit. Marvel humor, yeah.
Hey, asshole!
Asshole!
Get the fuck away from my friends.
It's so cringe! Couldn't even let us enjoy the explosion, you motherfucker. I didn't even notice the explosion was this. There's like the big explosion, right? And it just immediately cuts away. It's like, no. Don't look at that, don't look at that. We have a girl boss moment. We have a girl boss moment! Don't look at the explosion! Jesus fucking Christ. It just sucks, chat. So I found like a bunch of reviews and stuff. I found the Google reviews, and then there's like... Even like critics and shit. Oh, fuck off. God damn it. Even like critics and shit don't like it, chat. It doesn't really seem like everyone's or anyone's really defending it either. Banana man. So here's an article from Kotaku. I know, chat. You love Kotaku. I know. We all love Kotaku, chat. If you were hoping Saints Row would sate your hunger between GTA re-releases. Hasn't there only been one of these? Chad, didn't they only recently release one GTA game? And it was dog shit and it wasn't even in-house, they had somebody else do it? Right! I'm sorry! I can't make it darker, Chad! Oh, they keep releasing GTA 5 again! Are they re-releasing that? Oh, they just re-released GTA 5 all again? Oh, okay. Oh, it's getting Skyrimmed, alright. Ah, GTA 5 had 4 releases. Holy shit, I don't keep up with that. What the hell? The only thing I know about GTA 5 is the fucking, like, they keep, I need to put, like, some background music on this. Too quiet. You know, we can use Wii Shop music. They keep releasing, like, premium content instead of fixing the fucking games. Like, I guess on GTA Online, it's still easy to get doxxed. They still, like, fucking... I guess Rockstar hasn't fixed the whole, people being able to take your IP the second you join a public instance. You're glowing! I am glowing. Thank you. New skincare routine. First announced last summer, Saints Row is a full-on reboot of Volition's long-running series of GTA clones. GTA and Saints Row are really the same thing, right? Again, I haven't played Saints Row. I've only ever watched like other people play a little bit of it, but like Saints Row seems like it's more like I don't know. It doesn't. The first one was Saints Row diverted at 2? Okay. I was gonna say, like, they don't... I mostly watched gameplay of 3, right? And it didn't really seem anything like what I'd seen of GTA, but... Maybe somebody can correct me on that. All the polish in the world can't save a game that appears by many accounts fundamentally broken! Even Kotaku ain't defending your ass. Right now, Saints Row is sitting at a 63 review aggregation site. On review aggregation site at Metacritic. A rare low point for a critical beat that tends to collectively treat 7 out of 10s as an absolute baseline. Sure, some reviewers praised parts of Saints Row, including its character creator, which was released earlier this summer and is robust enough to instantly become a mini monster factory for players, and its new setting, the fictional Santo Elso. NPR described the writing as witty and compelling. But many reviewers were largely negative. Really? Really? Okay. Kotaku did not receive a review code for Saints Row ahead of its release. Aw, missed opportunity here. I think they would have really liked your game. But based on what our colleagues in the Gaming Press Corps have to say about it, this may be a blessing. I wouldn't wish a 40-hour sprint through this open-world game on any of my colleagues. Here's what critics have to say about Saints Row.
You know the test.
NPR likes NPR. Sarcastic Madman, thank you for $5. The Simpsons, Hit and Run, Scarface, and Godfather were some damn fine GTA clones, especially for licensed games. Monster Chief, thank you for the $5. Look up Saints Row 2, rest in peace, and watch the cutscenes to see a taste of old Saints Row. Big Q, thank you for the $5. If you ever plan on Saints Row 2 and don't have an Xbox, check out the mods that make PC port a bit easier to play. Dean Domino, thank you for the $5. You should play Saints Row 3 or maybe 4 too and watch movie cutscenes for 1 and 2. Axel Milan, thank you for the $2. I rated a not even worth pirating out of 10. Beyond Redemption. Saints Row 2 had an awesome story. So, yeah, it's just, Man, they couldn't even write their own fucking review. They just took a bunch of other people's reviews. That's kind of funny. They couldn't even fucking write their own reviews, chat. This is just a bunch of... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 original paragraphs here. 5 original paragraphs! And then the rest is just copy and pasting from like sites. Wow. Ooh, 2 out of 5. A lot to do in this game, but such an open world number checking. Even the stuff that sounds great on paper, like the permanent wingsuit that allows you to bounce off pedestrians. Head sticking altitude doesn't work quite right. Oh. I heard that this game has, heist missions that you can't actually partake in. Does anyone know if that's true? Is this, Or hold on, this is a walkthrough. Here's a walkthrough. Here's somebody playing the heist missions. Apparently there's like... Payday 2 type missions, or payday missions, in this game. But instead of actually doing the heist and like the bank robbing and shit, send us your picks. You wait in the getaway vehicle, I guess. I don't know how true that is. Here's gives us the most options. Yeah, so they're scoping it out right now. Is he using Bluetooth? I don't know. Not sure we want to go that way. Scoping out the front of the bank. No way, that's... Security here is pretty tight. We're gonna find out. Judging by the fact that this is only 4 minutes long, I'm gonna guess, I'm gonna guess that the, heist mission's on the...
They've got this store covered.
Don't, allow you to do much.
They're not messing around.
I think we've got what we need here.
Okay, give us a call when you want to do this.
Alright, start the heist, baby, let's go! The role feels so weightless in general. The fucking... Why do I keep adding a T sound to the end of shit? Holy fuck, I cannot speak
Hell
today.
Yeah,
hold on.
We are.
We'll be right there. Don't start without us.
Oh yeah.
Worked hard to get here. Let's make this count.
Look at this chat. Watch this shit. Wait for the crew. Hell yeah, baby! Is that a Gus Fring mask?
Hello?
Is this the sumbitch who's robbing my bank?
I didn't get my number.
Give me some time, and I'll put it all together.
So what are you gonna do? Call the cops?
Hell no. I've hired the best private army money can buy. Marshall Defense Industries.
Nice!
I've heard of them. You know, it'd be a shame if people found out about your secret list.
Fuck you!
Joni, Hartley's on.
Jesus Christ.
Just got in the vault. Buy us a little more time?
We just got in the vault. Sorry you can't be in here to help us. Sorry you can't actually participate in the fucking heist mission with us. You gotta wait outside in the fucking car.
Let's hope Hartley didn't know everything we did.
Oh. There you go. You get to kill some people outside the bank. You don't actually get to enter the bank though, fuck you. Holy shit.
Come on, let's go.
Oh my fucking god. There you go. Oh my fucking god. The VA soundboard does. There you go, chat. That was a heist mission. Small indie company, please understand, yeah. $60 game, please understand. You were becoming a big ascended weed. Star Wars bullets, yeah. The fucking... Did you guys notice the top of the police car? Like... There's a fucking, like, Gatling gun or some shit? So there's like a getaway mission, or a getaway race kind of thing. That's a little interesting. That's at least something, I guess. That's something.
Wait till you see what we found in there.
But I guarantee they also use the same like layout for a bunch of other missions, right? Like, I bet you there's like fucking a dozen other escape missions just like this. They just change the cop cars for like whatever the enemy cars are. They do? Yeah. This just makes me want to play Midnight Club. Is that a good game? In an argument, I think, with the $2, GTA and Saints Row are dead. Watch skill ups review. Control C, Control V. Yeah, that's kind of the vibe I'm getting. Literally drove in a circle. Did he drive in a circle?
I will take it from here.
Did the car fire in the middle? What's with the smoke? I don't know. Man. Skill ups reveal. Skill ups. Well, I'm not thinking of the 555. Look at how they massacred my boy!
This video is brought to you by Manscaped. Join over 4 million men worldwide.
Let's pretend heist? Wait, was that the name of the mission? Hold on. Was that the name? Oh, I skipped back to her. Wait, that was a Nixon mask? I couldn't even tell. What the hell? Oh yeah, let's pretend! Oh my fucking god. Well, at least they're self-aware. At least they're self-aware.
Who trust Manscaped with their most precious assets. Get 20%
off. No!
Saints Row. This is
Let's
not
pretend
good.
The game! It's theater of the mind, chat. You just have to open up your imagination, chat. You just have to open up your mind, chat. There's a game, but you just have to let your mind embrace it. And if you don't, well, that's on you, chat. It's like D&D, but you're paying $60 for it. And it's supposed to have the missions, and you're not supposed to, you know, play theater of the mind, but...
Watch my preview of the game, you will know that I went in with an
small indie
mind.
Company.
Initially excited about the prospect of a Saints Row
small
reboot.
Indie company.
That excitement was tempered by that preview window. I walked out thinking that this is probably going to be fine, basically. I was expecting...
Chat, I didn't fucking hear anything about this game. I didn't hear fucking anything about this game, chat. Granted, I don't keep up with, like, gaming news as much as I used to. Especially, like, when I was younger, right? I was like, oh, fuck, I know I show a Game Informer. Fuck yeah. Oh, I know I show a Game Informer. Oh, what's coming out now, baby? Right? I used to be really hyped about that shit. But nowadays, if it doesn't get shoved in my face, I guess I just don't care, right? Like, if it doesn't have, like, cyberpunk level of... brand awareness, I just don't even know this.
Expecting something pretty average.
But I feel like I would have heard about a new Saints Row game, right? Like, everybody was flipping the fuck out about a new Borderlands game.
Think I'd love it, but I didn't think I'd hate it. I really was not expecting something so...
Maybe that's what it was. They were trying so desperately to be like Borderlands that it's...
So aggressively bad.
People thought it was the same game coming out again.
Core gameplay, mission design, structure, technical polish, and in particular, narrative. The writing in this game is... horrifically bad, and I can't remember the last time I...
How can the writing be bad if there's a cat? How can the writing be bad, chat, if there's a cat?
Played a game this badly written, for real. Hard to know where to start with this one, but I think one starting point is to say that I don't think Deep Silver Volition were trying
Good
to
know
over our eyes with this one. I don't think they overhyped this. They didn't promise anything that wasn't delivered. They provided a lot of transparency in the lead up with gameplay trailers, a hands-on preview window, and
yeah, they were too
window.
Honest.
As I said in my preview, I really value that because
they were too honest by not saying anything at all. They kind of revealed their hand there. They didn't hype this shit up because they knew. They fucking knew. They were like, "Oh fuck." Our playtesters don't even remember what the fuck happened. They just kind of blinked. I don't know. How are we supposed to market this?
A lot of publishers and developers don't play it that way. And I think I'd be talking about this game in a very different way had Deep Silver Volition been more cagey in their marketing or crammed in a bullshit cash shop with XP boosters and currency packs and all the shit that pisses off in a bunch of other titles. So full credit for that.
They couldn't even be bothered.
None of that changes the fact that this is a bad game and I really regret the time I spent with it. To call this a reboot...
Look at how weightless it looks.
Because Saints Row 2022 is completely stuck in the past. This is the oldest feeling game I have played in years and I play boomer shooters. This is a campaign that is 10 to 15 hours of Xbox 360 era third-person corridor shooting, and it's an open world so lifeless that it's almost as though the past 20 years of open world design doesn't exist. The technical state of this product is...
I don't even think that'd be like a bad thing, right? I don't think that'd be a bad thing if it was like... Right? Because people still enjoy older games, you know? Just because something feels like dated doesn't necessarily mean that it's bad. I mean, that could be like its own charm, right? But this game has no fucking charm. It has no soul to it.
Very, very bad. And this needed at least 6 months to iron out all of the graphical, audio, gameplay,
modern open world kind of sucks.
Affecting bugs I encountered. More than that, though, this game needed like another 12 months of...
I love it when my shooting game does not allow me to kill the enemies by shooting.
Playtesting, because Saints Row is full of ideas that could have been okay, but each of them have one or more critical flaws that really make them awful, and more player testing would have found those things so they could have been sanded back. But the writing side of this equation, there's no salvaging that. Characters, narrative, plot, pacing, antagonists, it's a complete disaster. Had this game an actual plot, or had the moment-to-moment dialogue not been so cringe-inducing, I might have been able to go along with this. But when the reward for really repetitive, buggy gameplay are these painful cutscenes that make...
Look at how fucking bad the animations are, chat. I just can't get over it. I'm not usually the fucking kind of person that's like, holy shit, look at the animations. Oh my god, the graphics are so bad. But goddamn, chat, look at this shit! Fucking Mass Effect Andromeda looking faces and fucking Sim-style body movements. Holy shit!
Make your eyes roll every single time. That's the thing that makes you go... Oh man, I can't do this. And in fact, I almost quit this game about two-thirds of the way through because I was just like, I can't do this anymore. But I kept going for completeness sake, and yeah, the ending managed to be even worse than I could have anticipated. Oh god. Alright, so let's talk about this properly. Here's why I don't recommend Saints Row.
Wait, it's worse than it actually looks? You know, chat, they could have saved this shit. All they had to do, if they wanted to make back their money... Because apparently this game did not make back its money. I don't know where I, saw that at. But there was a thing talking about how, like, it hasn't made back its money yet. So, I mean, like, there's still time, you know, it just came out, but... Oh, yeah, this is the one that talks about the stock falling. Maybe that's the one that talks about it, losing money. You know what they should have done? It just came out, but it certainly won't. Yeah, I don't think it's going to. I don't think it's going to. Turn off that pesky ad block. I don't think it's going to make its money back. They should have marketed it as being like a very accessible shooter, right? They should have fucking like... made like a fucking like... aim assist? That was like god tier, and they should have put like a bunch of like accessibility controls, and then they could have tricked people into thinking that it was like revolutionary in terms of like game accessibility, right? And then with all the quirky humor and shit, they could have appealed to the normie crowd very easily. Baby easy mode, yeah.
We'll talk technical first. I reviewed Saints Row on PC on an RTX 2080
Complete
Ti
missed
and
opportunity.
AMD Ryzen 3700X. I played at 1440p max
settings at high level.
Max
well,
ray tracing. The one good thing I will say about Saints Row is that it runs pretty damn well. Most of the time, I was averaging around 80 FPS. When
this game feels like it would be a graft, doesn't it? Like, who the fuck was asking for this? Who, like, this does not feel like a labor of love. For Max Smiley, thank you for the $2. It's an ETS exclusive. G-Man's review is harsher.
Cruising around the city, when action would get really thick, that would drop to a floor of around 60, generally speaking. 98% of my experience was that. There were a few minor instances, usually localized to the desert locations, where frame rate would chug down to as low as 40 FPS. But like I said, that was rare, and my overall experience with Saints Row is that it's a well-optimized PC port, at least on my hardware. The preview build, which I played on a laptop, was similarly good. Now, not to take away from that, because a well-optimized PC
game
port
works.
Is rarer than you might think, but I would hope it...
You know what, Chad? You gotta give it credit. That is actually, like, that's a big thing. That is a big thing in this day and age, chat. The game actually working on launch? That's kind of fucking revolutionary, actually. The game, like, you can boot it up and play it, and it doesn't run at 4 FPS? And it's not crashing every 2 minutes? That's like... Chat, you gotta give him credit.
It runs well, because Saints Row doesn't look particularly great. This is a title that is also shipping to PS4 and Xbox One, and rather than making a current-gen looking game and then scaling it back, Volition essentially made a last-gen looking game and then made it playable across all platforms.
Oh, who the fuck cares?
Characters like detail, textures are extremely flat, and lighting is completely incapable of creating depth within a scene. The lighting in this game is essentially binary, like it's on or it's off. And while that's somewhat masked by the heavy use of high contrast neon outside, internal spaces really suffer.
That is so obnoxious to look at. Holy shit.
Somewhere to draw your eye towards
some environmental
detail. It looks like
Fortnite? Yeah,
and that just never happens. Every space seems to meld together in your mind as a result. I really can't recall any beautiful, well-lit scene in this game that wasn't entirely propped up by neon piping and glow sticks. That's a neat segue into a broader problem.
I think this looks fine. Like, I mean, I don't know. I'm not like a fucking graphics person, Jet. I think this looks perfectly acceptable. Right? I think that shit that they did earlier where like the fucking blue light was overtaking your screen, I think that was too much. But I think this looks fine.
With Santo Alesso, which is that the city really lacks visual distinctiveness.
It looks really flat.
It is subdivided into areas,
look flat. It looks like a mobile
low-rise,
game.
Mixed industrial, high-rise downtown.
But I don't know. I think
zone,
gameplay
fairly
is way
large
more.
Expanse of desert encircling everything. The thing is, though, while all these areas look different, they never look interesting. Just as I can't recall a beautifully lit internal scene, I really struggle to recall standout landmarks, boroughs, precincts, buildings, anything.
Oh, but look at the quirky Route 66 sign that has an alien glow on it. I mean, isn't that so quirky?
Volition have built a set of high-rises that are just...
There's a swordfish with Christmas lights at the base. Aren't you enamored?
Just a set of high-rises. They've built low-rises that are just a bunch of buildings and turnpikes. And they built a desert
that's a mission
that really
marker,
is
oh.
just a desert. Far more terminal than how last-gen the graphics might look is the fact that the overall art design of Santo Alesso leaves no mark on you whatsoever. One thing that makes these spaces even more difficult to take in is pop-in. If you've watched me for a while, you'd know that I'm pretty chill when it comes to this sort of stuff. I don't really care that much if a game has pop-in, unless it's directly affecting the game. And I think this is directly affecting the game.
Like, how?
Pop-in in Saints Row is so common and so noticeable that it becomes this permanent distraction when you're exploring the city. Buildings, signage, cars, people, trees, ground clutter, texture detail, all of it is aggressively popping in all the time. So rather than take in...
Okay, it is a little intense. I don't know, though, man. I don't know. I don't think, like, the popping in shit is really that big of a deal. Like, it is noticeable, but I don't know.
Sights of the city, your eye is constantly drawn to this pop-in since it's constantly flashing up before you.
It does feel like it was made to be a fucking mobile game, though.
I mean, if this was on low draw distance setting, I'd be like, yeah, fair enough. If this game looked incredibly detailed with amazing lighting, I'd be like, okay, well, that's the trade-off. But you've got a game that looks as basic as this, while also having
it's
this terrible pop-in, and with no option to improve it, even on high-end systems, and that sucks. This is made even worse by the fact that Santo Alesso feels eerily empty, something I'll talk more about later. But Santo Alesso is not teeming with foot traffic, or car traffic, or dynamic events, or anything. It always feels like a ghost town. Spider-Man on PC...
Yeah, I don't understand, like, why would you put a Saints Row game in the fucking desert? Is there anything about Saints Row that screams, like, the fucking Nevada desert? I don't know, like, where Santo Alesso actually is supposed to be, but, like... Why is it in the fucking desert? What about the fucking Saints Row games? Are you like, yeah, you know what this needs to be at? You know what this style... screams? You know what these characters look like they should be next? The desert. The fucking desert. Let's throw them in the fucking desert. You know what? You know where... Holy shit. You know where stylish gangsters should be? The desert. Here's the thing, right? Breaking Bad takes place in the desert. So basically, our game is gonna have more credibility if we put it in the desert, because we're gonna be the Breaking Bad of GTA clones. There you go, chat. I just explained it.
PC had vastly more going on the ground than Saints Row does, and you're not even meant to be on the ground very much in Spider-Man. Again, I could understand this looking more basic or having the...
Like, I don't fucking get it, chat! Look at the fucking bright purple vehicle in the fucking desert, chat! Why? Why? It looks so fucking out of place! Like, this is kind of like the style, right? Of like Saints Row, like the neon purple and the fucking like alien colors and shit, right? But like... Why is it in the desert?!
These draw distances, if there was a lot going on, but there isn't, so all of this can...
What about this screams gang? Maybe like drug cartel, but like...
Lines to make Saints Row look very, very
like... That's not what they're doing!
An impression that is more than mirrored in its gameplay. Before we talk about that though, we
really need to talk about the bugs.
This is brutal.
This
so
is like
just
the
context,
aesthetic, I guess.
Three
I don't
separate
know,
reviewers
man.
Reach out to me during the review window and be like, hey man.
Less buildings in the desert, less work.
Buggy?
Yeah, that's probably,
that
that's
is
probably
rare
the actual justification.
Concerning, because it told me that the experience I was having.
This is coastal people pretending they know what happens inland.
Was likely a very common experience. The first bug I encountered was at startup, and it was
Super
a
Bomb, thank you
bug
for the $5. It looks like they tried to do Vegas, but went too close to real Vegas outskirts. God. Phoenix Gaming, thank you for the $5. If you want some Saints Row history and general insight, watch Gypsy's video called Saints Row in GTA Shadow. I Live Again, thank you for the $5. I like Pippa reviewing games more than playing them. Loot Awakening, circa August 24th, 2020. Deal. Oh my god. Fuck off. Fireman, thank you for $5. Thank you, Pippa, for the excellent video game journalism. You truly are an amazing video game journalist. Shut up! Chris Walson, thank you for the $5. As someone who enjoyed Saints Row Reboot, don't waste $60 on this. Just play Saints Row 2. For Max Smiley, thank you for the $2. It's an EGS exclusive. G-Man's review is Harshare. Tyler, thank you for the $2. Why would you put enemy health bars in Saints Row? Is that, like, not a thing in these games? I don't know. Abtuasad, thank you for the $5. The worst thing about this is they're... We're probably never getting Saints Row 1 remastered or the Saints Row 2 DLC
put
properly.
The game, it gave me some random error about Epic Game Store permission or some shit. There were no permissions to
this
accept.
This is so
it kept
ugly.
Saying to accept permissions.
This is so ugly, chat. It feels like whoever fucking was like behind the art direction for this game, they were like, you know what I'm into right now? I got a whole ass Tumblr blog dedicated to the aesthetics of Red Dead Redemption. Breaking Bad memes, and I just played the new Borderlands game. I'm living the dream. Let's make Saints Row. Let's make Saints Row 2022. Let's fucking go. I am inspired. And that is what happened. Look at this shit. Look at this shit. It doesn't make any fucking sense, chat. Look at the fucking favicon. I don't know what the little icons are actually called. When they're not in, like, a fucking browser, right? But it's a fucking, like, it's the purple fleur-de-lis, right? And then you got this fucking cyan background. With this, like, Red Dead Redemption kind of text. And then just overall, like, a Breaking Bad kind of aesthetic.
The way I fixed this was just repeatedly opening and closing it. And then it eventually would work. So I had to spend 10 minutes clicking this button every time I restarted the game. Audio in this game is very buggy. Certain sound effects would bug out either during gameplay or in cutscenes like this.
What the fuck? Is that his character?
Some effects would cue and cut off really suddenly like this.
I didn't even know this one was
bad there. It's done. The biggest audio issue though is that the soundscape in this game just feels really...
I don't even care about shit like that, man. I don't know. For a $60 game, I guess that's kind of annoying, but like... I don't know, kind of like...
...really flat. Scenes that feel like they should have music don't, and a lot of sound effects really lack impact. I mean, this scene is a perfect example of both of those things, where I'm going through this big action sequence with no music, and my tactical shotgun sound...
Oh, it's $70? No, it's not $70.
Sounds like it's shooting soggy paintballs.
Look at these fucking animations, chat. Jesus Christ.
Hit registration during combat is very annoying because enemies will often become immune when they enter certain animations. Here's an example.
Oh, hell yeah, baby. Iframes, let's go.
Often certain mechanics just don't like work. Misled. Here I am desperately spamming the finisher button, but it's just not doing anything for no reason at all. This bug happens a lot. God. One time I was doing a mission and...
Chad, doesn't it feel like this was meant to be like a multiplayer game? This feels like one of those shitty multiplayer games that's free on Steam that one of your friends on Discord nags you to try and you boot it up and they're like, no, 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 it's so good, it's so good. This is gonna be like the next big thing. This is such a good game, alright? It's free. It's free. You don't have to spend any money, alright? It's been in beta for the past 8 years. But it's so good, dude. You gotta try it. And then you open the shit up and it's this.
And the cops were spawning in and I had to kill them. Okay, fair enough. After two waves of cops, a third spawns in.
Or maybe it's not free. It'll be like $4.99.
I did.
But you'll buy it on sale for $2.99 because it's perpetually on sale.
The great thing about where they spawned is that I couldn't shoot them. If I ran towards either end of the overpass, the mission would declare it out of bounds and I would have failed. Eventually, I did kill them with some cheesy head glitch bullshit, but God, I was very mad.
There's no indicator of what is and isn't out of bounds. It was just like a fucking, like,
game
fuck around and find
with
out.
Visual bugs. Some of them are minor, like this. Some of them occur in cutscenes, like this disappearing waffle. That's a minor one, though. The next one is a...
Post your lonely waffle. Wow. Be your own boss. Oh my god.
Some of them occur in cutscenes, like this disappearing waffle.
I swear to god, he better have added that sound effect in post. He better have added that fucking sound effect in post. There ain't no fucking way.
That's a minor one, though. The next one is a massive spoiler, so I want to give a really
clear
warning.
You did, oh, thank God.
It's from one of the most pivotal moments in the entire game.
Oh, thank God.
And I'm only showing it to you because it is so bad, and it really
Oh, spoiler warning, chat. Spoiler warning. As if anyone was gonna fucking buy this. Steven, thank you for the 159. I need to help make this, Pippa? No, you're fucking with me. Some guy from Ohio thing for the $5. It looks like it started off as a mobile game. Then they changed their minds at the last moment. It feels like that, doesn't it? It fucking feels like that. Tennies for breakfast thing for the $10. Okay, hear me out. So this series we built on being a silly send-up of urban open world gangster games like GTA. Yeah, so we're doing Avengers Borderland Edition. Fuck yeah. Pataki thing for going a big pee-pee. This game must be set in Alba. Quirky! The DA wins with $10, Walter.
Shows just how not ready this game is for launch. To have a moment like this play out this way. If you're going to play this game, do not watch this. Please skip to the timestamp on screen.
Chat, close your eyes.
A second to do that.
Close your eyes,
okay.
Chat.
Timestamp's there.
Look away.
All right, here we go. This is the final shootout with one of the central characters in the game. Here's how it goes down. Central characters in the game. Here's how it goes down. Shoot out with one of the central characters in the game. Here's how it goes down. So yeah, that's what I'm talking about when I say that visual glitches are more than just minor inconveniences during cutscenes. Visual glitches also have an impact on actual gameplay.
What? He dodges your bullets! Yeah, you can't kill him! He's Gumby, don't fuck around!
This is how it goes down.
Don't fuck around! What the fuck? What is supposed to happen
so,
here?
That's what I'm talking about when I say
he supposed to, like, fall over? But he's just still, like, standing there at the end? Like, what the fuck is that? That dude was morphing! They're like, what did Doctor think of the $5?
That visual glitches are more than just minor inconveniences during cutscenes. Visual glitches also have an impact on actual gameplay.
Jesus Christ.
The most regular and the most fucking annoying one is that red enemy health bars will often flash yellow. Now, this is a very big deal because yellow bar enemies are priorities. They have more health and you can't use your finisher on them. So seeing a yellow bar enemy is important. You pay attention to that because the game is built around them. And yet, owing to a
bug... That seems like an annoying mechanic in general, not being able to use, like, finishing moves and shit on them. I don't know. Some of the things with the $2 is too dangerous to be left alive!
Red enemy health bars will often just flicker yellow for a split second, and you're constantly checking these targets, only to find that they were not yellow at all, and the game is just wasting your time. This happens in like 50% of the combat encounters. It's so annoying, and while this game is playable despite this, I would absolutely classify it.
I mean, all these ones are still yellow, right? Disruptive.
There is a persistent glitch when you enter.
Naive hand on the $5 reminder that these people want to turn their games into movies. Oh, please God, no.
The flying vehicles. For some reason, the please, camera God, zooms no. in an absurd amount
what the
like
fuck?
This. You can't change that, so you then have to just get out of the vehicle. That's fine,
nice.
Except for this mission, where it occurred again, and I couldn't get out of the vehicle because it was a mission sequence, and restarting the checkpoint wouldn't fix it. And I was 20 minutes deep into this mission. I did not want to restart my game and have to do all of that all over again, since checkpoint progress isn't saved when you close your game. So I had to do the rest of the mission like this. It was truly terrible.
Wow, this looks fucking awful. And dusted.
Sometimes you can't fucking do anything other than move because all of the inputs are disabled. This happened to me on more than one occasion,
what?
But twice during a mission, and both times I had to
God, he looks so fucking dorky. Is this the enemy design? Is this just a random fucking enemy design? Fucking Moon Knight meets Reaper from Overwatch looking ass? What the fuck? So fucking ugly, man.
To start the mission I was on.
Look at him. Look at him. What the fuck is this? What is he supposed to be? Is he an... Are aliens a thing in this game as well? Or like... I don't fucking know. What are these guns too? How do you even... What the fuck? Please play this game? Oh my god. A Moon Man cowboy? It's Tuxedo Mask! Zoomer Outlaw? A new Overwatch skin? Yeah, this is a new Overwatch skin, I believe it. Oh my, Lily thing of $5. The absolute depths this game stinks to make Saints Row 3 and 4 look look like- Fuck, I can't fucking read. The absolute depths this game stinks to make Saints Row 3 and 4 look like incontestable masterpieces. By comparison, all the fans want is an HD remake of Saints Row 2, that's all we ask. Sleepy thing for $2. Dragon Nothing is $1. It's that guy who roams the park and tells you nothing is a coincidence.
On because reloading the checkpoint didn't fix it. In this one example, I was already like 15 minutes deep on this
thing
mission.
Of,
I was so pissed off when this happened.
Pay
but when
you to
did,
play this game
I,
all the way.
That's when I chose
though.
To quit
no.
Saints Row. I was like, no, I can't do this anymore. But then I came back as, like I said, completely sick. But I was very, very done with Saints Row in this moment.
This looks fucking miserable, chat. These enemy designs don't look bad, but they kind of just look like generic, like, construction workers or some shit. They're wearing, like, racing suits?
More
like,
fundamentally,
race track suits?
I don't want to say bugged, but they feel bugged. So using a controller to aim in this game feels terrible. I really couldn't understand why until this moment, when I was standing at a shooting range trying to track targets, I noticed that the cursor would move at different speeds even when I was inputting identical movement inputs.
What?
This is me moving my analog stick left and right over and over again, same pace each time. Sometimes you'll see that it's really fast, and sometimes it's really slow. There's no explanation for why that changes.
Are they trying to, like, make the aiming, like, progressively get faster the longer you do the input, but they fucked it up, so it just ends up, like, randomizing it? Is that what happened here? Is this like,
But imagine trying to aim with-
Aim acceleration! Yeah, it's like fucked up aim acceleration, what the hell?
That. That's what I did for 15 hours, and it was awful. This commentary on the state of the controls was shared by a number of people during the preview cycle, so I know I'm not alone in this.
I don't think I've ever seen anything like that. You should play Sunset Overdrive? Is that an actually good game, Pans? Thank you for the $5. The one they call Shandy, thank you for the 242. Watch G-Man's review. Still 710, thank you for the 333. Pippa, you should play this game just to see how much more you can break it. Oh my god.
Throw is unattractive to look at, both in terms of its technical fundamentals and its
what is a grenade design. Animation? I didn't even see it.
Was unattractive to a number of people during the preview cycle, so I know I'm not alone in this. Overall, Saints Row is unattractive to look
at. He does like a fucking jump kick for the fucking grenade animation. What the hell? Hold on. Go back. Do it again, man!
Controls were shared by a number of people during the preview cycle, so I know I'm not alone in this. Overall...
What the fuck? Jack, why do the animations just look so fucking dumb? Why? Why does he do that? Oh my god.
Saints Row is unattractive to look at, both in terms of its technical fundamentals and its artistic design. Because
it's quirky. Oh, okay.
It feels overly held back by last-gen hardware, without any effort put in.
Maybe he jumped. Maybe he jumped at the same time as throwing the grenade, so it like mixed the animations.
Current-gen consoles and GPUs. Santo Alesso lacks flourish and personality, and it feels like a ghost town. The game itself is buggy as hell, with a wide variety of immersion, mission, and...
Half of the animations are reused?! They're reusing the animations from the fucking Saints Row 3 game? No fucking way, dude. No fucking way. Holy shit. Did Matt Gaming, thank you for 333, don't know what's worse, this or Agents of Mayhem? Not a glory, thank you for becoming a big pee-pee? That? You don't throw your grenades like this? No! It looked better in Saints Row 3 and Saints Row 4? I don't know, man. It's $70. There's no way this game is $70, chat. It's gotta be $60. Oh my god. Put a poll in chat for something else to watch. This is making me angry! No. We're sticking with this.
Bugs. If you are ever planning on playing Saints Row, I strongly recommend holding off for at least 6 to 12 months, as Volition will need at least that length of time to properly fix everything that's broken here.
It looks like it's supposed to be, like, cartoony, but it just... isn't. It's like, I don't know.
Saints. We call ourselves the Saints.
Wow. That's such a powerful moment. I'm getting chills, chat. That or I'm cringing, I don't know. I can't tell the difference anymore. I'm in too deep.
Saints Row is a new start for the franchise, at least narratively. The old crew from games past are gone, and in their stead we have these people. We'll talk more about them soon, but let's talk about you
quirky,
first.
Millennial.
You do get to create your own boss in Saints Row's very flexible character creation
wow,
tool.
Beautiful.
There are no limits, and I went wild. I decided that my boss would essentially be the Wicked Witch of the West, which seemed like a good idea at the time, but then it resulted in scenes like this.
I can tell you love it.
Okay. I don't have to love it. I have to pay my student loans.
Please shut the fuck up.
Amen.
Realizing that it would be
Chad, if you ever want to make conversation with a millennial and just bring up, like, student loans and shit.
Absolutely impossible to take any part of this game's narrative seriously if I played a character that looks like this. I quickly reverted to a more traditional-looking character,
God.
But retained the British accent. Not a great choice. It's pretty rare to find-
That's a pre-made ass- What the fuck?! That's a preset?! I thought that was him trying to make a monstrosity! Oh my god! Chad, I thought he was fucking around with the character creator! Fucking preset! They want your character to look like that! No fucking way! I thought it was a fucking monstrosity! He tried to make look ugly, Chad, but no! No, Chad, that's just an option for you, Chad.
Character, but retained the
Holy
British accent.
Holy fuck!
Not a great choice. It's pretty rare to find-
Holy fuck! Flowerman, thank you for the $5. I guess you can say he had a Saints Row of bad luck while playing this game? Shut the fuck up. Handsome Morgan, thank you for the 156. Those who took student loans deserve their misery. It's a little bit busy singing with $2, but I want to pay my loans, Pippa!
Fine, bad voice work.
Oh, as a hard thing with $2, she looks like she majors in gender studies.
They all do. These days, I think the standard is so much higher than it was even 5 years ago. God. This voice acting is not...
This character design is just so fucking insufferable, Chad. The character designs are just so fucking insufferable. This guy, he's a copy-paste of, What's that guy's name from The Good Place? The annoying character that majors in ethics? The Good Place, ethics guy. He's this guy.
Aristotle was Plato's student, and Aristotle believes that your character is voluntary because it's just the result of your actions.
They intentionally fucking designed that character to look like the annoying guy. Well, the whole joke is that he's annoying as fuck.
Right now, you...
His whole thing in this show is that he's annoying as fuck.
You have made the insane choice to ignore the person who is literally trying to save you from eternal damnation.
No, yeah, I'm listening. I just...
It's the same character.
Be paying attention to these guys. It's like who died and left Aristotle in charge of ethics?
Plato.
It's the same character, chat. The difference is that Chidi is a well-written character. The Good Place is kind of a weird show. I don't know. I kind of enjoyed The Good Place, but it also is very, suffers from the, oh my god, quirky writing. But thank you for the $10. But I would take watching The Good Place over fucking playing this fucking game. Same character though.
Good. The character sounds ridiculously out of place in every scene. I actually don't think it's the voice actress's fault, by the way.
This is the only character that looks like semi-decent, and she looks like she fucking got ripped out of Fortnite. MK Ultra Victim, thank you for $2. It's Wednesday, my dudes! John Grayson, thank you for the $2. Did Reddit get a writing credit? The Daw wins, the DA wins, thank you for the $10. Kid named Finger, preset. Oh my god.
It's more the writing and the direction.
She looks too normal.
I spoke to my friend Lucy James.
I feel like in any other game, I would think she looks insufferable, right? Because she kind of looks like the quirky gamer girl, kind of like girl boss. Streams on the side, or streams for a living, or whatever, or has like a fucking huge Instagram following, like that kind of character, you know, the one that's like a supposed to be like a stand-in for, I guess, modern popular girls. I don't know.
About this, and she said it sounds like this person belongs in a different video game, and she was totally spot on.
Man, I'd hate to be the idols right now. Everyone at that party is probably gonna get killed.
Sucks to be Kevin Eli.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
We gotta go.
So with the old
was that supposed to be like a impactful? Like
Eli. Yeah. Everyone at that party is probably gonna get killed.
Sucks to be Kevin Eli.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
We gotta go.
I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to say, chat. Bazinga. Yeah, bazinga. Chat, that's like a moment that you'd see in like a fucking sitcom or like an anime game, right? Like a game, like a very fucking like a Japanese game, right? And it's not even funny. Listen, I'm one of those people, right? You know the meme where it's like game? And the guy's like disinterested, and then it's like game, parentheses, Japanese, and then the guy's excited. Chat, I'm unironically that, but even then, it's not funny there. Like, I don't know what the fuck they're doing, chat. The Almighty Lily, thank you for $5. The characters in older games are hardened thugs and criminals who have been gangbanging their whole lives. The new game, making the Saints a bunch of college zoomers, somehow makes them worse people, since it's not even like crime is all they know. Tyler, thank you for $1. Imagine being the Californian who thought they were making the coolest characters ever, and now watching everyone call them insufferably cringe. They had to have known. They had to have known, chat. Fataku, thank you for $5. I'm Captain Games T Quirk, or the Starship Kill Me, please! Agama, thank you for $5. Is this the California Hell game? Some guy from Ohio, they were $5. You know something is wrong when Fortnite has better looking female characters than most new games? Yeah. Oh, Raiders! Hello, Raiders! My name's Pipkin the Pie! And we're looking at how terrible the new Saints Row game is. Candies for breakfast, thank you, $5. Please make it stop. We're sorry for the mole jokes. Please just make the cringe stop. No. No. But yeah, that is like a very good point, right? The whole, like, the characters in the older games being hardened thugs. Like, these are a bunch of fucking kids, chat. These are a bunch of fucking kids that feel like they're from, like, an older generation slapped onto, like their personalities feel dated. I don't know what generation this actually was, because they're like Zoomers, right? But they have, like, millennial quirkiness. I don't fucking understand. I don't know who these characters are supposed to represent. But it's fucking terrible. It's fucking terrible. They just instantly come off as unlikable. All of these people, the way that they're dressed and everything, I look at these characters, and my mind just instantly goes to, oh shit, these are the kids that have really fucking rich parents, right? That go on Instagram and Twitter, and they have them, like, their bio, they're like, hashtag eat the rich, right? And they're fucking, like, going out partying every night, and you know exactly the kind of fucking people that I'm talking about. And this just screams them. It doesn't make them likable at all. These characters being thugs, all I can think in the back of my head is, okay, well, your daddy's gonna fucking pay your bail anyway, so do whatever the fuck you want. It's gonna get covered up anyways. I bet one of you already fucking murdered and did bad things to a woman. Alright, you guys,
The old crew gone, let's meet their replacements.
You don't give me
this
good vibes.
This is Nina. She's an art history major.
I'm not rooting for you.
Who wants to break into the art curation scene, but she's finding it tough. So she's also a member of a murderous criminal gang called Los Panteros.
Hold on, say that again?
She's an art history major who wants to break into the art curation scene, but she's finding it tough. So she's also a member of a murderous criminal gang called Los Panteros. This is...
Oh yeah. Her dad's rich. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Holy shit. Chad, my mama can... said that art students should kill themselves because they're gonna fucking just grow up to be in debt.
This is Kev.
That they're a fucking financial strain and leech on their families.
Substitutes not wearing a shirt for a personality. He wants to be a DJ, or he is a DJ, but he's also part of a criminal gang called the Idols who want to overthrow capitalism while we're... He substitutes not wearing a shirt for a personality. He wants to be a DJ, or he is a DJ, but he's also part of a criminal gang called the Idols who want to overthrow capitalism while... ...wearing Daft Punk helmets and throwing cool dance parties in the desert. And this is Eli.
Oh my god. He's literally hashtag eat the rich. Chat! Holy shit. Jesus fucking Christ, chat. There's no way this isn't parody. There's no way this isn't parody, chat! Holy fuck. Oh my god. Abtul as thank you for the $2. These people all deserve a Walmart trip with Pippa. Girl Kamui, thank you for $5. Okay, hear me out. What is it? This game is just a setup for the sequel where you get to kill these characters. Well, that'd be fun. Vash BP, thank you for the $1. Oh, slash Volition Game Dev, thank you for $1. Whoa, what if we made the characters a bunch of Silicon Valley douchebags? They're just like us, for real, for real. Oh, yeah. Dude, the average gamer's gonna fucking love these characters. And if they don't, they're problematic buzzword of the day here. Yo, fuck the people actually playing these games. SRV is everything in $5. As a cinema student, I can confirm this. Anon, thank you for the 1337. Your mom sounds hot. Tsunami, thank you for $2. Mama Ken was right. Dean Domino, thank you for the $5. Johnny Gat is a murderous psychopath in the older games with hundreds of bodies to his name. It's played for black comedy, but it works there. Dragonel, thank you for $1. I almost forgot. Almost 1.5k viewers right now. Holy shit. Congrats, Rabbit. I will catch his blood later. Please don't die of cringe. Oh, I'm gonna. Thank God I didn't turn this into a drinking game, because I was really convinced. I was like, man, I should play this and I should make it a drinking game where I take a shot every time I cringe. But I would have fucking died of alcohol poisoning, Jack. I would have fucking died of alcohol poisoning. There ain't no way. There ain't no fucking way, Jack. Soaring Bird, thank you for the 242. Capitalism is on suicide watch. Bob Snow, thank you for $2. Pay us $70 to overthrow capitalism. Yep. Yep. We're just like you, for real, for real. Now, turn our characters into cute little social media icons that you can roleplay as and make stand videos for. I don't know, whatever the fuck it is that they expect people to do with these characters. Because people sure as fuck aren't gonna be relating to them. Is this weed, dude, Lamont? I can't tell, chat. I can't tell. I'm not in deep enough. I can't tell if this is supposed to be weed, Lamont. But I'm kind of surprised it's not, if it isn't. On his shirt there? No? Yes? Think so? Oh, it's palm fronds? I can't tell. Lamal, dude, weed, lol! Jesus Christ. QB of Raging with 199. Shirtless guys, tattoos are all waffle related? No. Oh my fucking god. You guys remember when Waffle... Dude, oh my god, you know what gamers are gonna love? We should bring back the fucking Waffles meme. The fucking I Love Waffles meme from fucking 2010. Hell yeah, dude! Dude, modern kids, modern gamers, they fucking... Oh my god, you bacon! Oh my god! What the fuck are they thinking?! Why?! Why?! Holy shit. Holy shit, it has to be parody. It fucking has to be parody, Chad. There's no fucking way. God, this could have been, like, excellent parody if they had made this guy, like... Chat, they should have made this guy... They could have kept the whole, like, raver thing, right? They should have made this guy one of those, like... Super hippie, like, super progressive, like, oh, yeah, dude. Hashtag change and shit, right? Like, one of those kind of people, like, hashtag problematic, those kinds of people, right? And they should have given him, like, a bunch of, like... Ironic symbolism. They should have given him, like, tribal tats and shit. Oh man, it would have been glorious. Ultimate IRS, thank you for the $2. Eli just looks like 2010 Steve Urkel. Ultimate IRS, thank you for $10. This is just a low-end estimate of how much these people pay for a coffee. Yeah. Yeah, it probably is. Sebastian Cervez, thank you for the $2.56. You cannot stop capitalism, and this is a good thing. The DA wins thing with $10. Notice how eat the rich is the direct opposite of feed the poor. Hashtag checkmate, atheist! Aragum. Oh, yeah, you read that. Ursing with the $5. He's got a milk tattoo! That's racist! James Jameson, thank you $2. How does it keep getting worse? I don't know. He's an influencer too, I believe it. AK, thank you $2. You wouldn't have any vanilla soy lattes under the new regime, comrade! Cyclical water thing for $1. Saint Soy 5, Simp Team 6 thing for $2. Found the disappearing waffle.
Ev.
Yep.
He substitutes not wearing a shirt for personality. He wants to be a DJ, or he is
Hassan,
a DJ.
Yeah, they should have made him a Hassan parody. That would have been amazing.
But he's also part of a criminal gang called the Idols who want to overthrow capitalism while wearing Daft Punk helmets throwing cool dance parties in the desert. And this is Eli.
After something about $2, when are you going to teach Mi-chan about Lost, by the way, Anmo?
He wears a bow tie, he doesn't like to shoot people, he's really smart, and he listens to self-help audiobooks a lot.
Okay. And they think you're $1. Pippa, right now you're beating on these. Man, don't make it like a fucking. Don't compare me to like other people in gym, man. That's weird. Don't bring that.
In so, as I mentioned in the preview, I went in.
I appreciate you like. Trying to like be hype and stuff, but like.
In with an open mind with these characters. They aren't the typical badass crime people who are badasses and who do crimes. They're younger and they're all really nice people. Like, they'd help an old lady cross the street. And they're educated hipster nerds who probably take photos of their acai bowl and spiced chai latte breakfast to post on Instagram.
Yeah. Yeah, I bet they fucking do. Chat, all these characters are just what the fucking game developers wish they could have been. All these fucking characters. The writers for this game, they were like, oh yeah, you know what? You know what makes a good character? The fictional personalities people create for social media. That'll be an excellent character for my video game. You know what my character should be? As out of touch with reality as the people who are popular on social media. Fuck yeah. Gamers are gonna love this.
For the record, I don't think the problem with these characters is their starting point. There's lots of ways to do anti-heroes from Tony Soprano to Harley Quinn to Walter White to Wario. There would have been a path forward for each of these characters to make them cool and badass and really make you feel like you're hanging out with a group of dangerous, ruthless, winner-takes-all criminal entrepreneurs.
I don't even think you need to do that, right? Like, I think you could have kept all these characters the same, right? But if you were more self-aware about it. Because I don't think you're inherently a bad person when you're like this, right? I think these kind of people, generally, I think are very superficial. And shallow and kind of unself-aware. That's my like blanket judgment. Not everybody's like that. Some people they know what they're doing. Some people they're just doing what they know. But I think if you approached it as these being like real people, right? Like these are real young adults trying to find their way in life, you know. This guy, he's obsessed with the music scene and stuff, you know, he's obsessed with his fucking waffles and shit, you know, like you can still have like a good character there. He doesn't have to be an insufferable twat just because he's an annoying, quirky hipster. You know what I mean? Like, you could still have real characters here. And it doesn't have to be self-deprecating or anything. I don't want it to be like, oh, well, I disagree with, like, their fucking philosophies and shit. Or I think this is, like, cringe. So they're automatically gonna be bad no matter what. In the hands of a good writer, I think you can make, like, any character. Interesting, right? Because, like, these, like, in real life, you know, it's real people. Like, you're basing these characters on real-life archetypes. But you're just presenting, like, the social media version of them. It's like you base your entire characters around how people present themselves on social media, and it doesn't look like you gave them any depth outside of that. It's like they are entirely presenting as these fucking hipster ideals that generally people fucking hate. And you couldn't be bothered to just flush it out more. I don't know. It's kind of, it's like, it's kind of sad, I guess, because it is like a unique lineup, right? It's like, it's not what you would expect. And there could have been a lot of interesting conversations to be had, or like, funny moments to be had in the irony of like, oh, they're so nice, you know, they'll help a lady, old lady cross the street, but also they don't realize, like, the ramifications of what they're doing. You know? Like, they're so maybe narcissistic. They have no idea what they're fucking doing. They're so obsessed with, like, how things can look for social media, how they can, how they, like, are, like, brandable, or, like, marketing-wise, how they, like, feed their ego and shit, right? They're so obsessed with ego that they don't take into account like what they're actually doing. It could have like made for an interesting story, but I don't know.
But if such a path exists, Saints Row writers certainly didn't find it. These characters are so awful, hollow, facile, sock puppets. There is nothing to them. They have no emotional depth, no real personality beyond their surface level gimmick, no wisdom, no humor, nothing. They are the rough sketch that an artist might pen in a brainstorming session. So one-dimensional and superficial that you wouldn't even call them a draft. And then the writers try to awkwardly fill these scarecrows with some straw, and it always comes off so ridiculous. Like, there's this one...
Steven, thank you for 156. So, Saints Row 3. Helponents, thank you for the $5. It might have worked if they used it as a starting point and then have them evolve into badasses by late game. Would also like to see an end cap character. Tech Mac, thank you for the $2. The lead designer for this described it as millennial power fantasy. They also unironically did the gamers are mad thing on the game's promotional Twitter. So your joke wasn't that far off. The Falling Floor, thank you for the $5. These characters are the natural outcome of my OC, please no steal. People growing up and getting jobs in the industry. The Almighty Lonely, thank you for $5. They actually could have had something clever if the rest of the cast were spoiled rich kids. But the boss was still a murderous sociopath. Had the story be about them manipulating the kids into being criminals for their own gain? You know what? That would have been interesting. Like, I kind of think of, like, Until Dawn, right? I think, Aw, fuck. What's that studio? Is it Asylum Games or some shit? I forget the studio. Like, Until Dawn, I think, is a good example of having characters that are, like, more, like, modern and trendy like that, right? Like, kind of, like... social media normies, right? And then... not, like, sticking it to them, right? Not like a malicious, like, yeah, fuck these characters, you know, they're so annoying. But, like... having them go through, like, real difficulties and, like, a real... I guess, experience. I don't think Until Dawn is perfect, right? I think in the... like, the ending of the game and everything is not very impactful, and there's a lot of moments that are just kind of like, man, bitch, you deserve to die. But it handled it so much better than shit like this. I feel like it was like... it would have been like a good baseline, at least, for this game's riding the beat at. Cringe to endearing. Hmm. Big Fuzzy Hat thing with 333. This game needs a twist where Johnny guns down the entirety of the new Saints 5 minutes in and you play the rest of the game as him? That'd be amazing. God, do you remember when fucking DMC Devil May Cry did that annoying shit where they fucking, like, gave the new Dante the white wig or whatever for a moment and it was like, eh, nah. And it was, oh god. Sorry, that just, like, reminded me of that moment. Jamashu, thank you for $10. I remember someone on Twitter joked these Soylent Saints looked like they were the kind of people from... the kind of people the Saints from the role would bully. They were wrong. These nerds would get run over on the way to the mission. Yeah, they kind of feel like fucking, like, NPCs, don't they? They kind of fucking look... like NPCs, Jeff. Like, I'm thinking of, like, GTA NPCs, right? Like, I just played GTA 5 yesterday, right? And I just keep, like, associating them with the fucking NPCs I was running over. Jackie, thank you for the 333. So, an art major, a Twitter commie, and a black nerdy cuck that definitely screams gangsters? Well, I would have put it more nicely, but... and 333, thank you for the $1. Pippa, right now you're being... well, wait, I already read that. Where was I? Starting point. Penny B, thank you for $5. I listen to indie rock and dress like a stereotypical in the early 2000s, and this feels out of touch even to me. Certified D2%, thank you for $10. I've met IRL people like that, and they are rare but where I live, but when you find them, they get the primal urge for violence. P.S. How do I become a member? I don't know, you just hit the member button. I don't know. Thank you for the $10. I don't know. I don't think you should wish violence upon these people, right? Like, I don't like these kinds of people are really annoying, right? But, like, I don't know, man. Like, pity though. I don't think you should, like, condescend, right? Nobody's better than anybody else. But I feel condescended too when I talk to these kinds of people, right? I tend to avoid these kinds of people because I feel like I'm being condescended to every fucking time I speak to them. Every fucking time they open their goddamn mouth and I hear some stupid ass shit about how they fucking don't drink Starbucks anymore because it's not as fucking, like, eco-friendly as their new fucking, like, hipster chain that's fucking down the road that fucking sources their coffee beans from the fucking specific place that's been premium tested, and it's fucking $30 for a goddamn cup, and but don't worry, if you bring your own cup, it's only $26. You know, those kinds of people. Oh my god, I don't actually drink almond milk because actually I don't like that the packaging that it comes in isn't as biodegradable as the packaging for Soylent. So I only buy stuff that's in glass containers because I can reuse the glass containers for my Etsy shop. I put LED lights in them and I sell them on Etsy. Right, like those kinds of people. Hashtag recycle. Or hashtag upcycle. Gunship thing of 336. I'm pretty sure the writers and devs want to make them an over-the-top characters like in the previous title in this game. They went for millennials. Man, millennials just aren't fun, dude! I'm sorry, millennials just aren't fun! Like, I don't know what to say! They're not fun! They're just annoying! I'm sorry, like, I don't know, man. Like, if you had made it, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like there would be a way to, like, embrace the cringe, right? I feel like there would be a way to bring back a bunch of millennial memes that could be fun, right? Because, like, 80s movies. You look back at 80s action movies and shit, right? And those are, like, cringe, but they're, like, a fun cringe. They're, like, over-the-top action, like, oh, fuck yeah, this is so unashamed. So amazing. Too early? You think it's too early? I don't know. Like, I feel like there's gotta be a way, but it needs to be in the hands of better writers than this. Wendy's meme commercial. Holy fuck, Justine! That's what this game is! This game is the fucking Wendy's meme commercial. Holy fuck!
Fresco spicy chicken is so deliciously hot, it's generating reactions from everyone, like the memer.
Ooh, eat spicy goodness like a boss.
The selfiers.
They're good. Gotta get a selfie.
So hot, got a selfie or selfie.
And the behind the timeser.
This sandwich is da bomb. Raise the roof!
Wendy's new jalapeno fresco, our signature.
Yeah. Yeah, Chad, this is Saints Row 2022. This is the concept art.
Spicy chicken topped with fresh jalapenos and ghost pepper sauce. How will you react?
Chat, this was the inspiration for the game. They looked at this and they were like, what if we made that a game? And that's how you got this game. So there you go. There you go! Design cracked the case! Mr. Year, thank you for the $2. I think as a society, we need to bring back bullying. Does Lars thank you for $2 early and often? Carl, thank you for $5. I really enjoy watching the Pippa casually with no parasocialing or taking out a second mortgage to buy a ring at Jared's to one day propose. Not at all. Oh, okay, Carl. I'm gonna believe you. FC Blazers, thank you for the 242. I only wish violence upon them in Minecraft. Huh. Happy Big Wednesday. Just got home and found an interview with Momikin. Oh? Pimp Poppy, thank you for $5. That art major character reminds me of a certain historical figure in Germany. What? Dean Domino, failing if I ignore these characters and NPCs because the writers took the advice of write what you know to heart! Holy fuck! That's BP, thank you for $1. I'm better than these people and I'm a YouTuber simp. Oh my god. Tsunami, thank you for $2. Chris Chan likes to recycle. Good on Chris Chan. Following Pixie, thank you for $2. This is what V2 is for. Nez Rising with a 156. Okay, we need some eye bleach. Alexa, search Futanari. What the fuck?
One mission where Kevin asks you to run around to get him a Happy Meal toy. And you're like, okay, well, that's kind of dumb, but whatever, let's go with it. And eventually he's like, oh, well, I was an orphan and I never got one at the orphanage. And at the end of the mission...
Not this kind of game. No. Okay, what is this? I'm gonna just chance opening this. Oh? Serge Tankian's advice for young artists.
Do you have any advice for young artists?
Kill yourself.
Nice! Okay! Holy shit!
You steal a bunch of them after murdering like 50 people, and then this exchange happens.
There. You are now the proud owner of 500 limited edition Mecha Burgers.
Nah, I just want one. But maybe sometime you could help me bring the rest down to the county orphanage?
Absolutely.
Do you have any advice for young artists?
Kill yourself.
Oh yeah, I needed that the palate cleanser. Oh yeah, okay. Okay. Oh, God.
Proud owner of 500 limited edition Mecha Burgers.
Nah, I just want one.
Soothing, yeah, it's soothing.
But maybe sometime you could help me bring the rest down to the county orphanage?
Absolutely.
Now listen.
Yeah, let's...
Kill yourself.
Yeah. Okay.
I have feelings. I'm not made of stone. But my dude, you are a mass murderer. By this point, Kevin has already killed thousands of people. You think none of them had kids? You know how many orphans you put in that fucking orphanage? There's other examples like...
If they had made it self-aware, chat, it could've worked! Like, how would you salvage that? I'm not like a fucking writer, chat, right? But like, what have been that moment, right? I don't know, like, you could've taken from Borderlands, right? You could've fucking copied Borderlands. You took so much inspiration from Borderlands. In fucking Borderlands 2. Alright? Or Borderlands 1. I feel like they would've fucking been like, yeah, we'll take... Maybe you'll help me take those toys down to the orphanage? Main character be like, absolutely. And I'll be like... And then we can kill them all or some shit. I don't fucking know. Maybe he can like go psycho. He can be like, animal kill them all! Or some shit. I don't fucking know. Something, man! Something! Like, what the fuck was that?
This, where the game is so desperate to show the sensitive side of these characters as a means of giving them some backstory, some depth, but it comes off as the most ridiculous, supercharged ludonarrative.
My mom, but when chemo made her weak, I drove her around.
Dissonance ever. Oh, wow. Like Uncharted, if it sucked. And that's the thing, right? You still loved Nate and felt his feels even though he was a mass murderer as well, because the character and the narrative has been properly built to reconcile all of these narrative tensions or to help you conveniently forget them. But here, these characters...
I fucking hate when people do this with The Last of Us. People fucking... Oh my fucking god, the writers did this with The Last of Us too. They were like... Hey, you know how you got attached to that character? Well, actually, he was a piece of shit and he killed people, so he's a bad guy. If you don't remember that, if you felt for that character and you liked him, fuck you, you're a bad person. Okay! Okay, fucking get off your fucking moral high horse here, buddy! What the fuck are you doing?! You had good writing! You got me attached to the character in the first game and now you're treating me like shit for it? Okay!
Characters
buddy.
Oscillate so wildly and so regularly between concerned, moralizing, emotionally...
Meanwhile, this fucking game is the exact opposite. They're like, they got fucking shit writing, they got fucking terrible characters, and they're like, oh yeah. But they're not so bad. It's like, no. No, they are bad, actually. They are bad. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Hello, Pony Zing with $2 first time, a Twitter. I'm not supposed to say that word. Actually, donating food? Bahamut, thank you for the $2. Keep art as a hobby, get a real job till it pays? Pretty much. I mean, that's like anything in life, right?
Needy influences to cold-blooded sociopathic mass murderers that it's impossible to take either side of that equation seriously.
A character doesn't have to be a good person for you to care about them. Exactly, man. Exactly. Look at how many people get attached to, like, the sociopath characters, right? Look at how many people get attached to the villain characters in games. I don't think it's that hard. Right? I don't think it's that hard to make a character that's a complete fucking douchebag that people love. Patrick Bateman. Walter White. Yeah. The Joker. Handsome Jack. People fucking loved Handsome Jack. You want to take all his inspiration from Borderlands. Did you look at Handsome Jack? Like, why would you not, I guess, have your characters be inspired by that? I don't think it's wrong to take inspiration, but, like, I don't understand what you're taking inspiration from exactly. Like, you just like the aesthetics of Borderlands and you went for that, but you didn't actually, like, take a second to look at what made it fun? Eric, the Red thing with the Tillers, case in point, Red Dead series? I didn't enjoy Red Dead till, man. I tried playing the fucking story mode. I didn't fucking enjoy it, man.
This is one scene where a lawyer delivers you-
I could not get attached to the characters. Maybe I didn't give it enough of a chance, probably, but I could not get attached to the characters.
Do some court papers.
Oh my god, he's right.
Of course I'm right. I wrote the fine print myself.
What? Context?
Seriously, this is one scene where a lawyer delivers you some court papers.
Oh my god, he's right.
Of course I'm right. I wrote the fine print myself.
An unarmed civilian, gunned down in cold...
What? Well, chat, I don't get it. I don't... What was the joke? I don't know what the joke was, chat. I don't get it. I don't fucking get it. Random? Is it supposed to be low random? Is it supposed to be... Yeah, rest in peace, Rikada. Is it supposed to be the fact that he's a lawyer, so they kill him? I don't... I don't get it. Murder is funny? I don't know. Neil Druckmann, thank you for $1. Please look forward to buying The Last of Us Part 1 for the third time next week! Hell yeah, just in time to sweep all the game awards this year! Now if you excuse me, I need to find the dead horses to beat. Hell yeah, good luck, Neil.
...blood, and this is just a few minutes after this scene.
Hey, we had a big win today. We should do something irresponsible to celebrate.
What do you have in mind?
Oh,
these characters have no fucking personality.
I don't know, the money fight!
I've never seen something so out of touch in my fucking life. I've never seen... Why is that gonna join in the money fight? My boss was like, money fight? Oh, fuck yeah! Thank you for the 50 gift subs. For those of you who are new here, that's my boss. Holy shit.
Oh, I don't know. The money fight!
God.
This is one of the many examples of the game trying to show some.
It's so fucking insufferable, chat. How are they supposed to be hashtag just like me for real, if they're fucking throwing around money and being like crazy with it?
Some affection between the group members. There's a lot of these and they are all this goofy.
I don't know, being that wasteful with your money and potentially damaging it and not being... How do I put this in the most pretentious and annoying way possible? like, not being very, like, aware of, like, other people's struggles and being so, like, dismissive and, freely acting with, like, your money like that is, actually very, like, hashtag problematic. And actually, I feel like by doing that, you're kind of, like, trivializing other people's issues with money. And I feel like just because you came from, like, a rough beginning and just because you want to overthrow, the rich people and hate capitalism, doesn't mean that you should partake in the systems that are used to oppress others like that? So freely?
Part of what I spoke about in my preview is that you never find out how these four people came together. You are not properly introduced to any of these characters, and so this
I don't want to. The less time we spend getting to know these characters, the better. I don't fucking want to know. I don't want to know how they became friends. I bet you they met in college. I don't want to get into that. I don't care. I don't fucking care. You know what the fucking backstory would have been? They met at a protest or some shit. I don't want to fucking deal with that. I don't want to fucking deal with that. Not when your game has nothing to say. Listen, I'm not one of those people, alright, that's like, oh, don't put politics in anything, okay? If you want to put politics in your art, you know, I feel like that's pretty normal, alright? But I just know in this fucking game, it's just gonna be insufferable.
Familiarity.
They cannot handle it well.
It's annoying because it's almost like the game kind of
They can't handle it well enough to convey the things to people they agree with in a good way. There's no fucking way that they're gonna, like, be able to make just a good story that surpasses any, like, oh yeah, like, I don't. Like, that's the power of art, chat, is to present ideas in a way that makes people who disagree with you see things in a new light. See things from a new perspective. Be it politics or emotion or religion or whatever the fuck you want to do, right? Whatever you want to portray. But if you can't do it well, man, it's just fucking insufferable. That's just ammunition against you. Holy shit!
Assumes that you already like these people and want to hang out with them when you do not.
Oh, fuck,
shifting
no,
to
not.
A new cast of characters who are so different from the previous game without giving any of those characters a proper introduction.
Does anybody actually want to hang out with this kind of person? Does anybody really? I feel like it's just like a social obligation. It's just a social obligation in order to make yourself look good in the social hierarchy. Who the fuck actually wants to be friends with somebody like this?
It's a very bad call, and the game never recovers from it. Outside of these characters, the game...
did not give anything with the $2. Can we do Out of Touch by Hall and Notes for Karaoke to honor this game? They been on things with $2. Will Sakuna ever know the joy of a money fight? I don't know,
and
man.
Overall tone is
I mean,
weird.
He did just participate.
I think it's probably best demonstrated by this speech, which seems to indicate that the Saints are about overcoming the constraints imposed by middle managers or something.
Life is hard enough without having to deal with middle managers, with no discernible talent telling you how to do your job, without having to deal with assholes who have had every opportunity handed to them, but never had to fucking work for a single one of them.
The subtitles didn't match at all, and I was trying to read the subtitles. What? What's she going on about? McDonald's job?
Saints are about overcoming the constraints imposed by middle managers or something?
Life is...
It's... Hold on. Let's go back here. Okay, life is hard enough without managing to deal with middle managers with no discernible talent telling you how to do your job without having to deal with assholes who have had every opportunity handed to them, but never had to fucking work for a single one of them, without being told that your time will come, you just have to wait, be patient. Well, let me tell you something, we're fucking done waiting. What? Chat, I don't get it. What? Was that ESL? I don't know, dude! What? Is this something the average person is like, yeah, this is my real issue in life?
Outside of these characters, the game's overall tone is weird. I think it's probably best demonstrated by this speech, which seems to indicate that the Saints are about overcoming the constraints imposed by middle managers or something.
Life is hard enough without having to deal with middle managers, with no discernible talent telling you how to do your job. Without having to deal with assholes who have had every opportunity handed to them, but never had to fucking work for a single one of them.
This is...
What? Like that... That's like your big, like... sticking it to the man moment? Is your boss telling you how to do your job and he's a nepotism hire or some shit? Like, what? Like, that's what you're mad about? What? That's like your big issue in life, is your boss is a bit of an asshole to you. What the fuck? Or you're stuck in a dead-end job? Like, what? Motherfucker, that's not empowering! What the fuck?
It's one of the game's awkward narrative through lines. The idea that the Saints exist as a response to student loans and rent and millennials being told to wait their...
Was this game made by a retail employee? I don't know, man. Like... That's so low stakes! Like, what the fuck? Like, yeah, like, having a shitty boss sucks and, like, not being able to climb the ladder sucks, but, like... What?
Their turn. Again, there would have been a way to properly interrogate or satirize these things within the context of this game, but like Eli's bow tie, it's just...
Is that really worth killing people over? Like, hold on, let me just put this into perspective here. Is that worth killing people over? Is being stuck in a system of monotony and mediocrity worth murder? That's your big... That's the thing that has you setting out, putting more children in those fucking orphanages that you grew up in? Is living a goddamn mediocre life? Holy shit, dude.
Just window dressing as a stand-in for substance, other than the briefest, most fleeting references to things like...
Yeah, the wagey cage! The fucking wagey cagey! Turn them into fucking murderers. What the fuck? Yeah, is this postal? Is this horseshoe theory? And you got postal on one side and Saints Row 2022 on the other?
Late stage capitalism or corporate greed. There's nothing insightful or humorous said on these subjects. I'm not expecting Saints Row to be Pulitzer Prize winning literature.
Okay, incandescent rat thing with $10, you did that pretentious voice a bit too well, I don't like it! And on the year 333, these people are so insulated from the real world by Twitter and their own vortex of mentally ill friends that I don't believe they are capable of writing anything but bad caricatures of human beings. I don't know, man. That's PP thing of $1. Here's how you fix it. These people start off as total dongs. They do crimes because of their money troubles, and they ironically become more decent as criminals because they gain some actual life experience. Too bad the devs probably have none of that. Tech Priest thing for $5. If your problem is the bobs in accounting, you're not oppressed, you're bored. Bob Snob thing for the $5. I say we raise student debt and lower the price of ammo and ropes. What the fuck, man? Bob Snob, thank you for $5. Oh, I already read that. Me and Jane, thank you for $4.53. That speech is like a seething tweet thread. It fucking is! Steven, thank you for the $1.56. They've got a Zoomer moping mission. Because you got fired. Wait, is that a real mission in the game? John Garrison, thank you for $2. They're the true victims of society. Glow in the Dark, thank you for the $2. Ultimate cringe, blank. Not allowed to bring up politics, man. Dean, the mean old thing with the $9.99. You know what the first Saints Row was about? Low-income neighborhoods plagued by gang wars and having to band together to fight back? because police and politicians won't help. Oh my god, a real problem. Oh my god, a real thing that might drive people to do things that they otherwise wouldn't. Or things that are morally questionable, but can be understood and empathized with because their situation is so dire and so just difficult that you can be like, yeah, you know, I understand. I understand. But like, being stuck as a fucking cashier at McDonald's? Bro, that's gonna turn you into a fucking murderer? Like, what the fuck? Holy shit. Infested Runner, thank you for the 690. Thanks for being here for us, Pippa. Chat, I'm like fucking like 4 missions deep into GTA 5. And I fucking hate Rockstar. And there's been so much more depth of character in the fucking 4 missions and the brief glimpses I've seen of the fucking GTA 5 characters than having the entire fucking game summarized to me. The fucking Saints Row 2022 characters are so fucking paper thin. It's just amazing. It's just fucking amazing.
Literature. I'm not expecting it to win fourth place at the local book club's quarterly literary...
Julius Cannon said you were going on big pee-pee.
...slam. But if you're going to brush up against these subjects, then at least do something with them. The overall narrative of this game is no better. It lacks clear plot with a beginning, middle, and end. It doesn't have...
I'm not going to point out the fact that all the villains are dressed like goddamn Colonel Sanders.
...distinct acts punctuated with notable events. None of the characters have personal arcs within the...
In before battered wife.
...the overall storyline... There are some antagonists, sort of, but only one of them is properly introduced. The others are just kind of there, and you don't even know you're about to bring them down until it happens. I really genuinely never knew at any point where I might be in the overall storyline of this game, because in the absence of clear goals, clear villains, and clear acts, the whole thing feels so adrift. When I got to the last mission, I was like, oh, last mission. Okay, sure. I didn't see that coming because the story was never building to anything in a coherent way. So this is a really damning assessment of this stuff.
Was that the villain? Does the villain get a redemption arc? Chad, I fucking hate that. Chad, I used to love redemption arcs for villains, but I'm so fucking tired of games where they bring in the fucking redemption arc for the villain and they use it as a justification to make the main character actually not a bad person. They're like, oh yeah, the main character, they're not gonna resolve the final conflict with violence. Or maybe they will, but they're not gonna kill their enemy because actually they're better than that. And the other characters, the villain's gonna come around and they're gonna turn into a good person as well. And actually violence isn't the answer and fuck you as a player for taking in it.
It all really gets to you because it's so relentless.
I wonder what I'm salty about.
Every single mission is the same concoction of annoying characters spouting bad dialogue while you do something that doesn't clearly fit into a bigger picture because there is no bigger picture.
This game has no fucking impact, Jack. Holy shit. Holy shit.
Like, listen to this.
This is gonna be an epic statement. That yacht's guarded AF.
Dude, did you just say AF?
Yeah, an abbreviation.
First, we fucking swear all the time. Second, it's only an abbreviation when texting. AF, as fuck, same number of syllables.
Please shut the fuck up! Just stop! Stop fucking talking! Holy fuck! How do you write dialogue this fucking annoying?
Okay, fine. This is gonna be an epic statement because that yacht is guarded as fuck.
And every bleeding one of them is going to learn what happens when you try to blow up a saint.
Hells yeah!
Now imagine having.
Chat, I didn't think you could make characters more annoying than Claptrap, but they saw Borderlands 2. They saw Borderlands 1, they saw Borderlands 3, they saw. How many games are there now? Why do I always default to Borderlands 2? I think I enjoyed Borderlands 2 the most, so I always default to that one. But like... Holy shit. They saw the fucking Borderlands franchise chat and they were... Holy shit, there's 5 of them now! What the Chat, they saw Borderlands and were like, Claptrap? Oh yeah. What if we just make all our characters that little annoying?
Having to listen to that for 15 or more hours. That is
Oh, there's four! And the pre-sequel. Okay. Holy shit. But Pip, all the Borderlands games are bad. Nah, fuck you, I enjoy some of them.
This has already been pretty brutal on both a technical and writing front. I wish I had better news for you on the gameplay side of things, but I do not. As one note and one dimensional as Saints Row's characters are, so too is its open world design, structure, mission design, and open world gameplay. I've already spoken briefly about how lifeless Santo Alesso feels as you move through it. This is reflected in how it plays as well.
No
Santo
Alesso is completely impact. Absent. Even like crashing into that car, it was like a minor debuff.
Any sort of dynamic event that might interrupt your regular thoroughfare. It's a city of rival gangs, but zero rival gang fights. It's a city of hustlers, but nothing of note is ever taking place on the sidewalk that might grab your attention. There aren't random police car chases, or bank heists, or carjackings, or street
Everything
races.
Is so
nothing
scared.
Goes on in the streets of Santo Alesso, other than what you make happen. So, if there's nothing dynamic going on, what about the scripted events that take place at map markers?
Just, chat, doesn't everything about this just feel like a fucking mobile game? Who's some other thing with the $2? Saints Row be bussin', no cap, for real, for real. Devo DeVito thing with the $10. Imagine being the poor recording engineer or dialogue editor who has to work on this garbage because it's a step up from working on a Hallmark movie. Bro, at least Hallmark movies. Alright, listen, at least you can put on the fucking Christmas Hallmark movies, alright? And you can be, like, in for a wholesome experience, alright? At least there's, like, a fucking, like... At least you can feel something other than just... pure cringe, right? Like, this is just... I'd put Hallmark movies at least two steps above this. I don't like Hallmark movies. But at least, like... God, I don't know. It's all grift, though. It's all grift. Glow in the dark, thank you for the $5. Redemption arcs are over and usually... are overdone and usually childish, shallow, and cringe. True. Tyler, thank you for $1. When the combat you're in is less dangerous than the cringy, casual combat chatter? Yeah, the fucking dialogue will kill you in this game before the actual mechanics do. Mother Eagle, thank you for the $2. How did no one tell them this wasn't gonna work? Echo chambers, man. Fataku, thank you for the $5. There's no one left to play the straight man when all the Oh my god. Egotistic Killers, thank you for becoming a big pee-pee. Danny D, thank you for the $5. The third one received perfect scores from GamesRadar and I think an IGN award? Saints Row 3? Zulahai, thank you for the $10. Also, you developed an interest in the character over the course of the game. You want to get back at the person who killed your best friend. Let's teach you why that's wrong.
Well, there are a lot of map monks.
I mean... I don't disagree with the message that's like that revenge is wrong, but like just the way they go about it, man.
Because sure, some of them involved running around to dumpsters and clicking on them so you can find some trash in the dumpster.
Hashtag upcycle.
Sometimes pallets of drugs are left on the street and you just collect them by clicking on them. There are these
There were so many like fun things I could have done, man. Like if you're gonna be like picking up drugs and shit, man, if you're gonna be going to McDonald's to get Happy Meals toys, at least let it reflect the reality, right? There should be fucking you should be able to go behind the McDonald's, right? Or not behind the McDonald's. You should be able to go into the McDonald's parking lot and that's where all the drug deals take place. Yeah. You should have a mission, right? To go to McDonald's to like pick up coffee for everybody or whatever, and then just on the side. You know, you find the dealer in the parking lot. That should be like a...
History of Santo Alesso yeah. things that you can find, which make you stand and listen to boring exposition for 30 seconds. And you do that 5 times and then you get some cash.
Did you know? The Grand Prix is a celebration of innovation, ingenuity, and industry.
There are side hustles.
That's a main mission in the game.
Like being a getaway driver, for example, or flying.
Did you know when you don't pay your voice actors enough, they cannot be bothered to record good audio dialogue?
flying a wingsuit around town for a bit. They're fine, holy but shit. They're really just less interesting versions of the same stuff you do in the main missions, and they're pretty skippable. The headline feature of the open world is the Criminal Empire stuff. After a few hours, you get access to this map that lets you set up fronts to generate cash. Each
I
one of them is essentially
ground,
a hub for side quests,
oh,
where you steal things as a repo driver, or you jack cars for a chop shop, or you jump in front of traffic for insurance money.
Okay, that one actually looks kind of fun. I actually kind of like that. That actually looked pretty enjoyable, though. That one, I don't know, that was like the best thing I've seen in the game so far.
When I encountered these things, I really imagined that each one would be its own unique questline with different types of missions to do.
Oh, they stole it? They just reused it from the other games? Oh my god.
That is not it. Each one represents one type of mission that you have to do multiple times.
They just took
so
it from the other games.
Okay. Cool. And then I had to steal 10 more cars. Each time it was the same. I would just drive over to it. I would press a button and get in it. I would start driving, the police or some gang members would suddenly appear, they'd follow me all the way home, I would park the car, and that was it. Every single time, 10 times. Same goes for the insurance.
At first I was like, man, he's just describing like every game, right? Like, oh yeah, a shooter, you know, you just hold your left mouse button, you aim at the enemy, and the enemy dies. Right? Like, the way he was describing it, I was like, man, that's like... Yeah, no shit, dude, like, that's how games work, right? But then it was, like, showing the fucking, like, police following you all the way home. It's like, you really couldn't be bothered to, like, I don't know, add, like, a qualifier that you have to get rid of the fucking police? Good pause, thank you.
Insurance thing. The first time you do this, it's pretty fun. Then you need to do it 6 more times. It's always exactly the same, just at a different intersection. Furthermore, to progress the main story, you need to complete at least 2 of these criminal ventures. So at one point, you find yourself stealing 10 cars in a row, which took like an hour to do. And then you're bouncing in front of traffic 6 times in a row, which took nearly another hour to do. Given how
Jet, if I have to do the same kind of mission for more than 10 minutes, I get bored. That's why I fucking hate escort quests. I fucking hate escort missions because you're fucking locked into doing the same exact fucking thing for like over 10 minutes. I fucking hate escort missions. And I fucking hate games. If it's not a fetch quest, I don't want to do it. I enjoy other kinds of missions, right? But like, if it's not like go kill some enemies or do a fetch quest, being stuck basically playing a fucking mini game is the most annoying shit to me. People shit on fucking escort quests are like go kill X enemy. But dude, I will fucking take that so much. So I will take 10 hours of that, dude. I will take 10 hours of that because at least I'm fucking doing something versus being stuck playing a goddamn minigame where I'm not engaging with the core mechanics of the game.
Competitive these ventures are, building this stuff into the main campaign.
The only thing that, like the stealing a car thing, that seems like it'd be a bit more interesting. But even then, it's like I'm not getting to shoot in my fucking shooting game. Really?
Bad idea, and it really.
With how fucking dog shit the driving mechanics in this game look, I don't want to fucking do this for an hour.
Really took the fun out of these things. Though in the case of robbing cars and just driving them somewhere,
that
wasn't that much fun to begin with. That brings us to the main missions. This was the part of the game I was probably most pissed off with. There is an astounding lack of imagination with regards to mission writer here. 98% of the missions you do are all drive here. Oh shit, some bad guys appeared. Let's shoot them. You shoot them and that's the mission. Already I can hear people being like,
God, the fucking anime designs are so fucking cringe. Jesus Christ, chat. Zuhart, thank you for the $10. Oh, wait, no. Anon, thank you for the $3.33. I want the real millennial experience. Where's the driving for Uber Eats mission? They should have put that in, man. Mr. Yura, thank you for the $2.22. Writing purposely ironic cringe is really hard to do well. This seems to be an especially awful example. Going back to Anon, right? Where's the driving for Uber Eats mission? These are not the people writing for this game are not the kind of people that would ever publicly post about driving for Uber Eats, right? They're not, like, people do not think it's, like, trendy to drive for Uber Eats. So it will not be in a game. Even though it's like a reality of life, having to do like shitty little side jobs and shit in order to earn some extra cash. Because it's not palatable and aesthetic. Nobody wants to put it on here, right? It's not like the right kind of suffering. Yeah, they're the it's only the people. They'll only brag about eating Uber Eats, right? I don't want to call it, like, suffering, right? But, like, I guess the mediocrity, I don't know. I don't know, man. I don't know how to explain it well.
You could say the same of Halo. Yeah, you could. But you know what? Halo's good, and this is not. This is really shitty third-person
classist mentality.
Shooting.
Yeah, that's the thing with this fucking game, right? Is it's... I'm gonna sound so annoying here, but like... It is classist, isn't it? It fucking is classist. The whole thing about this is it's like these fucking, like... At worst, upper-middle-class motherfuckers. And I know they're like, oh, they went to an orphanage and oh, man. Look at the fucking way that they dress and act, man. Like, fuck off. Fuck off. You can give them whatever fucking backstory you want, dude. But at the end of the day, these are some upper middle class motherfuckers that you're throwing on some old poor me backstory still. And trying to paint them as, like, speaking for the people. Fuck off. Off, man! Holy shit!
...that would have felt dated at the tail end of the PS3 era.
LARPers? Like, yeah, unironic fucking LARPers. This is like when somebody on fucking social media, right? These are the kinds of people, right? They go on fucking, like, Instagram, and they post, like, this goddamn sob story about how, like... Oh my god, it's so hard. I've had to cut back from 10 Starbucks. I used to get Starbucks every single day. On my way to work. And I had to cut back because times are really hard. My landlord just upped my rent. And I can't have a Starbucks coffee every single day anymore. Because then I'd have to dip into my Genshin Impact funds, and I don't want to do that.
Like I said in my preview, you can't even switch shoulder perspective. There is no proper melee combat system. The weapons are as bog standard as you can get.
I fucking hate these children!
And when they try and get funky with their design...
Chet! I can't fucking deal with it, Chet. I can't fucking deal... I feel like I live in the lap of luxury, Chet. I feel like I had it pretty good growing up. Alright? There are times when there was, like, no heating. There were times when there was, like, not shit for food in the house, Chet. But I don't feel like I ever, like... suffered, you know, like growing up, right? Grew up pretty much redneck in the countryside, and then as time went on, my parents got better jobs, and eventually, like, we had a fucking boat at one point. We had a fucking boat, right? It wasn't like could go out and eat fast food every day kind of thing, but it was like pretty good, right? And I felt like that was a lot, and now, like. I probably couldn't get fast food every day, right? But, like... I can get fast food, like, pretty much as I want, you know? I feel like I live a pretty fucking good life. And then I look at these people... And I just don't know how they fucking do it. I don't... Chat, I don't know how you be so fucking miserable. I don't know how you fucking have all these goddamn problems when you can spend fucking $600 a goddamn month on Genshin Impact, fucking buying your goddamn Starbucks daily, fucking, like, buying new clothes every goddamn season. Like, what the fuck, chat? What the fuck? You did not fucking, like, speak for the average person there. Holy shit! Shut the fuck up! Shut the fuck up! You are so fucking annoying. Like, maybe I'm fucking, like, projecting. Maybe it's my own insecurities, chat. But it's like, shut the fuck up. You are so fucking annoying sitting in your fucking ivory tower. Fucking didn't have to fucking worry about shit going to college, man. You were like, oh, yeah. Yeah, maybe I will go to college. Maybe I won't. I don't know. You know, it's kind of just up to me because I can just fucking afford it. Fuck off! Shut the fuck up! You're so fucking annoying. God, I'm getting actually mad about it.
They become almost unusable for how clunky they are. With core gameplay this week, you really need to have interesting mission design, and that is so absent here that it's alarming. There's always some narrative window dressing to get you to a place, but when you get there, it's just shooting people or driving a car, or shooting people when driving a car, or driving a car while your buddies shoot
people. God, I want all the fucking, rails here, holy shit. let's get to the super chats. Oh god, where was I? Awkward silence. Glow in the dark thing with the $2 game needs a soul. Our game needs a soul, has a bland college kids. Rob Red thing with the $5. Listening to this man describe this game makes me have a sudden understanding of retro gamers. What? Kusama thing with $5. Raise high the great pink flag of Pipkin Pippa the Thought. Wait, Pipkin Pippa Thought. Unite around the party and Chairman Pippa. What the fuck? Glow in the dark thing with $5. Cringe character, my allowance that mommy gives me doesn't cover the mansion, so I fight for the people. Unironically. Fucking unironically, man. Oh man, my LA apartment only has 2 bedrooms instead of 3. I have it so hard. My fucking LA apartment that is fucking like $6,000 a month. The landlord upped it to fucking $6,500. How will I survive? It's like, man, what the fuck? Shut the fuck up. And I'm thinking with the 202 perfect stream. Arcana Plague thinking with the $10. Little advice, if you play Saints Row 2, use the PS3, Xbox, 360, PS Now, X Series, PC version. If I recall correctly, there's occasional screen tear. The Steam version has a habit of crashing. Landlords, like, I don't fucking talk about landlords. Holy shit. I don't know why the landlords thing annoyed me. Like, I'm not gonna be like, oh yeah, landlords are so great or whatever. You know, landlords are fucking annoying, right? But holy fuck, shut the fuck up. I don't know, like, what it is that pisses me off about people complaining about landlords so much now, but it just annoys me. I don't know why, Jack. I don't know why. I haven't processed those fucking emotions. I don't know why it annoys me so much. But the constant fucking bitching about landlords. Shut the fuck up. Just shut the fuck up. We get it. Landlords suck. Shut the fuck up. It's the self-righteousness? Is that what it is? I don't know, man. I don't fucking know, man. Danny D, thank you for the $5. It's the same as people who cry about work and bills, but literally their parents are rich and pay all their bills? XYZ, thank you for $1. I can't afford Starbucks every... Yo, yeah! Chat! Chat, here's my favorite fucking thing. When people go on social media and they complain that their parents are making them pay like their own phone bill. Or they're like, times are really rough right now. My parents just started making me pay my own car insurance. You're 22! Get on it! Like, what? And no shit, they're making you pay! What? You want them to fucking take care of you? Your whole fucking life? Like, what? Oh yeah, you're 30 to the lot on the fucking... Oh my god. Master handing for $50. They have money, but no soul to fill the void in their hearts. Yes, I fucking did. By the way, thank you for the $50. Jesus Christ. Carol Leo, thank you for becoming a big peepee. AG Parabellum, thank you for the $350. You're too base to stay alive, therefore you're my Yoshi now. Thank you. True Novice, thank you for becoming a big peepee. Yeah, my god, it's your car! It's your car! Yeah, no shit, they're making you pay your insurance. What the fuck?
Oh my god, there's so many of them!
But come on, chill up, is it really that bad? Yes, it definitely is. I feel like Far Cry is a really important... Come on, Sheila.
I don't even remember what the contact was.
Oh my god, there's so many of them.
But
oh my god, this.
His voice line activated when there's one fucking enemy on the map. Holy shit.
But come on, Shilup, is it really that bad? Yes, it definitely is.
Holy
I feel
shit.
Like Far Cry is a really important point of comparison here, because Far Cry gets a lot of shit for being pretty played out these days. Like, we've seen this formula since Far Cry 3, it's
meant.
Time to update
yeah.
it, etc. That commentary
Holy
is accurate,
shit,
but I do think it doesn't give enough credit to just how much work goes into Far Cry's mission design, encounter design, and core combat. All of those things in Far Cry are excellent. Far Cry Sandbox is so strong that it's able to regularly produce action that looks pre-scripted.
I like that Far Cry doubles as a hunting simulator. It's kind of like Oregon Trail. You can play the actual game, or you can just turn it into a hunting simulator.
When it's not, and when you
why buy big game hunting when you can just buy Far Cry? You can buy Far Cry, you get 2-for-1 deal.
Combine that with Far Cry's innovative mission design, you often get fantastic sequences that few games can match. If the best moments in a Far Cry mission can hit 8 or 9 or 10 out of 10 in terms of spectacle and intensity while still remaining fully playable, then the best Saints Row ever produces is like a 2 or 3.
God, it looks like a
the core gameplay
mobile
mechanics
game.
Are so weak that they will leave you fixated on how underbaked and repetitive
Christ.
All of the mission design is.
It looks like a fucking mobile game, Zach. Like, the more I look at it, it's like
outside of everything I've discussed here, there are a lot of little features peppered throughout Saints Row. There's the
all the buildings look the fucking same.
Outside of everything.
Jesus Christ. I feel like that's, I don't know, this is like a dumb complaint, I guess, but I feel like that's something that a lot of games don't capture about smaller towns. Is there's a lot of diversity in like architecture, right? When you live in like a smaller town, or when you drive through like Nevada, right, and you look at like ghost towns and stuff, or like the more like historic towns, there's such like a diversity of building. And I guess, I don't know. You just don't see it in games.
Everything I've discussed
it's a very,
here.
It's a very like small complaint, but I feel like the approach that a lot of game level designers, the approach that a lot of game level designers take to designing maps is they make everything look like it's a big city, but smaller, right? Like they're like, okay, all the fucking buildings look the same where I live, so I'm just gonna copy and paste some fucking assets for everywhere. And it's like, man, it just looks so boring.
Yeah, there are a lot of little features peppered throughout Saints Row. There's the ability to customize every car in great detail. Same with
I live in a small town. You have half the town with a lot of old classic architecture. The other half is basically brand new. Yeah, because that's one of the things about small towns, right? Is shit does not get, like, torn down and rebuilt all the time. With cities, it's like, they'll, like, there's some, like, historic landmarks and shit, right? There's some things that are kept historic. But with, like, old towns, whatever building is there, right, is it just stays there. You know? You'll go into, like, smaller towns, and they have buildings from, like, the fucking 1800s right next to buildings that were built, like, more recently. But you don't see that in games. I don't know. That's like, a very, like, I don't expect that or anything. I just think it's kind of, like, a shame from, like, a world-building perspective. But for talking thing with the $10, I'm a landlord, and it's not easy. I can't raise rent and twirl my mustache at the same time. They raise property tax, and I can only get S-Buckies once or twice a day. Oh, no! That's pee-pee thing with the $1. Play the Saints Row 3 trailer again, Pippers. I need the pick-me-up. Oh, my God. Glow in the dark thing with $5. I was a landlord. If I was a landlord, I would enjoy messing with these people. These people sound like grown children.
With every weapon. Both weapons and vehicles have signature abilities that are unlocked after
The church around here is from the 900 or something? What?
Completing certain challenges. Want your car to be able to do barrel rolls? There's a signature ability for that.
Okay, that's kind of fun.
Decorate your base. I like to put porta potties everywhere. There's the ability to summon your
okay, that's pretty fun.
Companions to
I like
you in
base
the open
customization.
World. There's a bounty app allowing you to track wanted targets.
That anime's kind of neat. He's got like some unique animations. I don't know, the bright colors and shit, like, work when it's like a mini boss, I guess. But like seeing like these random enemies running around in these bright colors, it just looks kind of dorky to me. I don't know. They feel like it feels too forced, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what the exact problem is, but it just doesn't work.
Targets for some quick cash. There's so much, to be honest. And in any other number of games, it would be really impressive. But here, I kind of wish this stuff didn't exist, because obviously a huge amount of effort went into creating it, and that effort could have been directed towards fixing this game's core issues.
Look at like how floaty the bullets
feel. Bugs is the most obvious and immediate one. This game needed fewer boondoggles and more time in the oven to make it actually playable. It needed a
I see no one. Skilled video was wicked AF! Kill me. Oh, come in a star this thing here, the $2.
Complete rethinking of its open world design philosophy to bring it into the modern era. It needed a completely different cast of characters and an entirely new script. It needed way more diversity in terms of mission design, and it needed significant renovations to its core combat mechanics.
Man, as long as the combat was good, everything else could have fucking taken a backseat, man.
I don't like being this brutal, but this is a very poor title, and I absolutely do not recommend it.
Jesus Christ.
Gentlemen, have-
No! No ad. Yeah, the rest of it's just Ned. Thank God he puts it at like the at the very end. God. The game needed diversity, but in gameplay? Play the ad, Pippa, now! No, I'm not playing the ad! You guys can go watch the video, man. Listen, yeah. Saints Row is terrible. Reveal by SkillUp. Go check it out. God. That was very painful. Hold on, I'll spam this in chat. I feel bad. I just did like a whole fucking react moment. I need the... How do I... Oh god, my Chrome is frozen. Oh shit. Hold on. Okay, well, while that's... Here you go. Hey, remember when Saints Row was fun? There you go. Oh god, I can't fucking... It's fucking broken! Hold on. Oh my god. Why is it frozen, chat? Why is it frozen? Rest in peace, Chrome. Mute? Copyright? Oh well. There you go. There's that video that I watched. If you wanna bookmark it. DMCA? Wait, did I get DMCA? Rest in peace, Vlad. Plug in your mouth. What the fuck's happening? You spoke at me, chat! We already played it! It's fun! Who cares? DMCA, be sure that I don't fucking care, you bitch! Sorry, that was a little aggressive. I have a lot of pent-up anger right now, Susan. Please. I'm sorry. They actually look interesting. This guy looks like a fucking badass. He's got the giant fucking necklace. Motherfucker is styling. Motherfucker looks fresh as hell, chat. This guy, he looks like he'd fuck you up. He's got like a nice like fucking leather jacket. What is this material called? It's like leather, but it's not like it's not like shiny leather. It's like, I don't know what this is. Is it just leather? Pleather? Is it pleather? Pleather. He's got like this fucking nice pleather jacket. He's got fucking the slick back hair. He's got the fucking like, I'll kick your ass and fucking spit on your corpse glasses. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the this. Oh. I missed it. They have like so much personality, man. And then this guy, he's got like the fucking blood splatter shirt. He's fucking like signing an autograph for like girls. You can tell he's like the more like playboy type. He's like popular with the ladies. He's like a little micro celebrity. Probably insufferable. This guy, he looks like he'd be really fun. Is that Erica singing? Yeah. This guy, he's got like an ominous vibe, man. And just in general, like, everyone looks like they're having fun. Like, it looks like it's a fucking, like, experience. Like, this looks like somewhere I'd wanna be, right? This looks like somewhere that I would want to be. Versus, like... Can I find the exact spot in the fucking video again where, they're at the fucking rally? They're doing, like, the big fucking speech for why you should support the Saints, bro, right? Why they're, like, why they're, like, the good guys. The fucking... Here's why you should support the Saints, you know? We're gonna stick it to the middlemen. Yeah, fuck those guys. You have to rise up, fight the power, you know? Fight the fucking middlemen telling you how to do your job. Where was that at? I can't find it. But they're just standing out in the fucking desert! On the fucking balcony of a goddamn, church! It's like... Right here! Right here! Right here, chat! Where would you rather be? You wanna be standing out in the fucking desert? Watching two fucking college kids complaining about middle management? Or at a badass party? Where do you wanna be, chat? Where do you wanna fucking be? I don't even like clubbing! I've never been to a club! I'd rather be here! Neither will. Yeah, that's fair. See, he looks so fucking cool, chat! He looks so fucking cool! This girl! She's got the fucking, like, FBI thing, but she's working with, like, these gangsters. She's like, what is she? She's like a traitor to the fucking government. She's like an insider. She's like a... gonna expose our secrets and shit. Also, she's pretty. I'd rather be inside playing games. Well, yeah, same. He's just got so much more fucking personality, man. It's like... I don't get it, Jeff. The ball sucks. So God. Muted Pipkin? I'm muted? I don't think I'm muted. God. Graphics look good. I mean, this is a fucking rendered cutscene, man. Not rendered cutscene. This is like a rendered trailer. But the girl in the FBI jacket is a super freak. I'm too sad, thank you for the $2. I'm sorry, thank you for $2, I'd rather be inside playing games. And all my Luli, thank you for $5, reject middle management, embrace the Kanye pill. Regrets going to art school, thank you for $1. So fun fact, one of my professors in college was the prop and environment modeler in Saints Row from 1 to 3. The first game was meant to be a parody of GTA. The next few games, obviously, were always meant to be... to get more ridiculous, not this. Man. So... Saints Row was meant to be a parody. Like, it wasn't meant to be a GTA clone. It's supposed to be, like, a parody. I'm sure, like, that's how they pitched it, is that it would be, like, GTA to investors in order to get funding. But, like... God, chat. Like, the fucking Saints Row games, like, actually look fun. One was kind of serious, two and on the parody. It looks fucking fun, chat. I just... I don't get it, chat. What's the Saints Row 2 trailer? Saints Row 2 trailer. Blood, gore, intense violence. Rated M.
Many of you know the restoration of Saints Row was a tremendous success. That was just the beginning of what Old Tor has in mind for Stillwater. Picture this. Glass towers, clean streets, and no...
Was that a GTA reference? Is that a Final Fantasy reference?
Towers, clean streets, and no... below the poverty line, trying to wash your car. Oh. So how do we do that?
Launch trailers, it's not equal actual trailers, just FYI.
Gangs cripple each other. We direct funds to the Stillwater Police Department. Pretty soon, all those nasty little gangbangers are gone.
What you do to piss these guys off?
Don't worry about it, Pierce. We'll take care of it.
What the fuck you mean, don't worry about it? These guys are packing space age shit.
Characters with, like, fucking passion in their voice, chat.
So what's the point?
Imagine.
We get our crew together. What's...
Imagine your characters actually sounding like they actually care. Can you imagine? Can you imagine, chat? I know it's difficult. Weekend Warrior, thank you for 449, sending some pipkin pesos for the cute rabbit. Thanks for making fun of this terrible reboot. It deserves all the mockery it gets. It deserves to fade into obscurity, but thank you. Moth Eagle, thank you for the $5. Play the new Saints Row game, please! Except for the... I'll play Saints Row games, please, except for the new one. Oh. Whee! Thank you for $1. When are you gonna answer your marshmallows, nerd? I'm bad at keeping up with those. I have a backlog of 800.
Finish off the Saints, or being fired is the least of your worries.
Chat, all I see when I see their logo is Final Fantasy. Wow, actually cool character designs? Wow, characters that actually look like they'd fuck you up? Can you imagine? Wow, a character that actually looks really fucking cool? Oh my god? We can't have that. What? Wow. Wow, gritty violence from gangsters? Oh my god.
Kill a few elephants.
Oh, I didn't know what he said.
Tower, you're gonna have to kill a few elephants. If you're gonna build an ivory tower, you're gonna have to kill a few elephants.
Okay. Wow, oh my god, was that a game that actually looked interesting to play? Were those characters that actually looked real- He's the bad guy in parentheses. Yeah, thank you, James Jameson, I would've never noticed. Wow, a game that actually looks fucking fun? Wow. Wow. You know, I don't know. I don't know if I want, like, interesting looking characters and fun looking moments. How about, I don't know.
Middle managers or something?
Life is hard enough without having to deal with middle managers.
I sure hate middle management.
No discernible talent telling you how to do your job. Without having to deal with assholes who have had every opportunity handed to them, but never had to fucking work for a single one of them.
No, man, I don't know, there are these character designs. You know, I don't know, I'm kind of hooked. I don't know. I don't understand why middle manager though. I don't know either! I don't fucking know either! I wish I did!
This is one of the game's awkward narrative through lines. The
Jesus
idea.
Jesus Christ! Hold on. Is there like. Cutscenes. Come on. Give me some cutscenes, man. Buying this game. You may leave! Don't do it! Don't do it! Oh, cutscenes. Oh my god. There's holy shit, fucking 5 hours? There's 5 hours of cutscenes! Holy shit, chat, that's actually a lot.
Thanks for the
You know, I'm gonna give them credit, chat. 5 hours of cutscenes, that's like 3 more hours of just like content that's even usually in like modern games. Like that's actually kind of impressive. You know, usually you fucking spend $60 and you only get like 3 to 6 hours of gameplay, but they actually made that much time in cutscenes. Wow.
Right. I'll see you around.
5 hours of padded cringe. I mean, that's true. It's more cutscene than gameplay.
Need air support now. Stand down. We don't got time for hero bullshit.
Don't worry, I got this.
God, it's so boring. God, it's so fucking boring. I couldn't tell if that was an NPC or if that was like a statue at first. I think it's a statue. I don't know. It kind of just looks like the characters, man. I don't know. Music? Music? Oh, shit! Yeah, there's no music! What the fuck?
Gwen, we've got a problem.
Hang
Is there
on.
BGM? No. I guess not.
Oh, shit.
Did they show the voice actors? What they were dubbing over?
The cavalry's coming.
Whoa, we're gonna slam into
the- shit.
Oh! Oh, shit. I just slammed into this, this bridge here. At high speeds on my fucking alien technology fucking spaceship. Oh, shit.
Hang on, the cavalry's coming.
Oh, shit.
Oh no, yeah, what a slight inconvenience, jackass, yeah. Oh. Oh, man. Damn, that kinda sucked. Oh, wow. What the fuck?! This is getting nonsensical, it fucking is nonsensical. But not in a fun way. It's not even nonsensical in a fun way, it's just fucking dog shit, man.
Come out with your hands up!
Not today.
Oh, fuck. Oh. There's... How am I even supposed to make fun of it, Jen?
Hands up.
No. Oh. Oh.
Come out with your hands up.
Not today.
Oh, fuck.
Oh. What? Oh. What? Oof, ouch. God damn it. Oh, fuck. Oh, God. Come out with your hands up.
When,
what the fuck is this game? Okay, I give him credit for 5 hours of fucking cutscenes, chat, but no. No, I don't know if I count this. I don't fucking know if I count this, chat. Holy shit!
Get a beat on these guys.
Oh, if only someone had told you to stand the fuck down.
Oh. Oh. Jesus Christ. Fataka, thank you for that. Voiceover was done during COVID and she didn't want to wake up her parents. Ah, that makes sense. You know, that explains everything, actually. That explosion painful sound. You're setting your standards too high, there's not even any BGM. Wait, there's like... some like... sound effects, like there would be BGM, but it feels like there's like... It's like they only kept like the sound of... I don't know, man. Egotistic killers, and you're the 1399, this is abysmal. Did they even check the lines and mixing, or did they outsource the audio to someone else? I don't know. I don't know, man. God. This is gameplay? This is the cutscenes.
You have more courage than brains.
Goddamn right I do.
Chat, this is some of the worst shit I've ever seen, chat. Holy fuck. I play a lot of dog shit games. Oh my god. Dr. Disrespect lost the blood. No! Oh! Holy shit, is that the Dr. Disrespect? No, come on, chat. That's mean. He has better acting than this. Wait, no. Do the other kick again. Do the other kick again. Hold on. Chat, watch this. Watch him fucking knee her. Right here. That one! Yeah, what the fuck?!
You're too predictable.
It's fucking terrible, chat.
Am I?
This is fucking terrible. Am I? Oh my god. Didn't even connect. It did not look like it even connected. Chat, they only animated it from like... They had the camera set up right and they just like lifted the model's knee. They didn't bother to check to make sure it actually did connect or anything. They were just like, yeah, let's just throw that in there.
You tried. I'll give you that.
Get your hands in the air!
God. Andromeda level? Oh my god. God, this is just sad, chat.
Well, you didn't die. All in all...
She is fucking hideous.
Not a bad start.
Holy shit. Oh, I missed like a bunch of super chats. We'll just live play.
Jesus Christ!
Mom Eagle, thank you $5. Play the Saints Row game, please. Some new ones.
This is for
Tyler,
you.
Thank you $1. I spent too much on supers and now I can't afford Starbucks. Let's fucking go.
Is this a joke?
For Max Miller, thank you $2. Look up Saints Row 2's courtroom or Jimmy's
death scene.
There's
supposed to be a bonus based on exceptional
performance. Rule in the dark, thank you $5.
Right.
New game seems more a virtual signal. Virtue signal than a game. A Saints Row as a series is about over the top action like 80s action movies.
I can look you in the eyes and say you didn't do what
the absolute highlight of Saints Row. This is too loud. I feel like it's distracting. The absolute highlight of Saints Row 2 was stuffing one of the rival gang leader's girlfriend into the trunk of a car that he crushes in his monster truck rally. Holy shit. That's fucking dark. What the hell? Low in the dark thing with the $2. Upper management tends to be more a-holes. Some weird guy thing with $2. Oh my god, is that they? Fucking Peppa, what a treat! Captain Thunderbolt thing with a 350. San Francisco hipster self-inserts didn't work for Watch Dogs. And it won't work here either. People don't like hipsters. Jenny Marcalius, thank you for the $10. The game's terrible, but still fun and a mindless, silly, playing a bad cult classic from 2009 kind of way. Saints Row 3 came out in 2011, by the way. Glow in the Dark, thank you for the $2. Big Peepee Squad, holla. Pataka, thank you for $5. The voiceover was done during COVID and she didn't want to work with her parents. I read that. IT Weed, thank you for $5. All the lead devs on this game should unironically leave the gaming industry. Seriously, their career is done. Let them learn from their mistake and never do the same shit ever again. Let them never do the same shit again. Let this be a lesson that they will fucking take on to every other project they work on in the future. They won't learn. They probably won't. Egotistic Killers, thank you for the 1088. This is abysmal. Did they even check the lines and the mixing? Oh, I read that. Silica Beastmaster, thank you for the 606. Saints Row 3 had you having an epic aerial battle at the beginning. Saints Row 4 had you climbing a nuke in flight to Aerosmith. What the hell is this nonsense? John Gerson, thank you $2. Not the best take, the only take. Jefferson Olvera, thank you 39 cents. Please play this atrocity, I implore you. I'd fucking pay the $60 for this shit! And I'd just get bored instantly, chat. It would just not be fun. You gotta look at the cringe from afar, chat. I don't want to give them money for this either. Well, the dark thing of $100. I respect that the man's mustache, but this drama club level acting and choreography.
And I took it. And if you were in charge, it would have been an inspired decision. But you're not.
I am. This is a warning. Fall in line or find a new job.
Oh. So that, Chet, that's the backstory. She didn't like her middle manager. At her space agency job. Okay.
Fall in line? Damn it. Damn it.
Chat, I hate people that hate the rules. For no reason. Chat, listen, rules are obnoxious, right? Rules are obnoxious. Some rules are meant to be broken, and some systems are just inherently fucked. But, like, you're working, like, a military-esque job where people's lives are on the line. You should fall in line. You should listen to your fucking superior. or you risk getting other people killed. Like, that's not even like... This isn't even like fucking like McDonald's being like, you have to throw away food that people bring back, right? Like, I think that's dumb. Like, jobs where at the end of the day, you know, they're like, oh, well, we have to throw all this good food out. We can't do anything with this. You can't take it home or anything, right? Like, that's a rule that's meant to be broken, right? Like, fuck you. You know what? You know, fuck you. Fuck you. Why waste the food, right? But this shit, like, this is what you're mad about? If somebody doesn't want you risking other people's lives and your own, for that matter, doing reckless shit? Okay.
Damn it, damn it, damn it.
That's fucking entitlement, man. That's... You think you're better than everybody else? You think you know more than everybody else? And you have to change the system to accommodate you. Because your ego is so fragile that you can't handle the idea that other people might know more than you.
Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it!
It's fucking terrible.
God fucking...
She's flipping the fuck out about it.
God fucking damn it all!
She didn't even fucking fire you! You didn't even get like a fucking like... written warning or whatever! You got a fucking mild scolding! Like... Your boss was a little harsh on you. Oh no, poor baby! Poor baby! Your fucking boss told you to fucking act right or find a new fucking place to work! Oh no!
Every last fucking bit! God damn it all!
Jesus Christ!
God damn every last motherfucking microscopic itsy bitsy teeny weeny son of a bitch bastard ass tiny little shit sucking bit of it!
This is so dramatic, Jack! She's so fucking overdramatic! What the fuck, dude?! Is this meant to be parody?! Holy mother, first world fucking problem! Yeah, Menhera, this is fucking like actual mental illness! Jesus Christ! Ratman, thank you for $5. How dare I have to do what the people who pay me say, I know! Sheesh, thank you for $1. Hey, babe, nice badonkers. Love you. What the fuck? Penny, thank you for this. $4.99? Political thing I can't say. I wouldn't be surprised if they turned Johnny Gat into a spineless snowflake. Pippa, watch the Saints Row 1 and Saints Row 2 cutscenes and compare. Oh.
You have
right now, we're just embracing this cringe.
Hey, it's Kev. I'm baking up a slamming congratulatory brunch for when you get home to celebrate your first day on the job.
First day on the job! She fucking acted up on the first fucking day! And she's throwing a bitch fit! I could have sympathized at least a little! If it was like, oh man, she's been stuck in this shitty job for so long. She's been stuck in this shitty job for so long. Her manager's always being a bitch to her. She knows how things should actually be done. She knows the ins and outs of her job. And she knows what should be done, right? Because like she's so much more experienced. Maybe like her manager just got hired over her. And her manager doesn't know what the fuck she's doing. But she's bossing her subordinates around, like she fucking owns the place, you know? First day on the job, bitch!
It's gonna be dope. Oh, and it's official. I'm gonna be spinning at that Idols party I told you about, so... Hope you can come. TTYL.
Yeah, throwing a fucking tantrum like a child. First day on the job.
So excited about your new gig.
Holy shit.
I heard back from the museum.
Holy shit, actually fucking insufferable. Also, would it kill you to put some fucking background music in? Would it kill you to add some fucking background music to your goddamn game? What's the matter? You couldn't license the, like, anything? You couldn't get fucking Kevin McLeod? Hold on, I'll help you out. Give me 1 second. Give me 1 second. Hold on. Oh my god. My fucking Chrome is all fucked up. Hold on. Give me... This is gonna take 2 seconds. Just hold on. Kevin... Oh no, I'm on my... Hold on. I'm gonna go so far out of my way here. I'm gonna go deep on here, man. I'm gonna...
Gross. Anyway, I'm glad one of us had a good day at least.
There you go.
See you soon.
Hey, it's Eli.
It's not very fitting, but at least it's something.
Speaking of which, when you asked to borrow my copy of Be Your Own Boss, I assumed it was because you
needed Yaggedy Zach. Hold on.
The coffee table. So let's talk about
Yaggedy Zach.
Can't wait to hear about all the HR forms I'm sure you had to sign.
There you go. Ah, so quirky! So quirky! Oh my god. She has roomies too. She has roomies!
Oh, everything smells amazing, Kev.
You know what would make it smell even better?
Hey man, if you want a $300 waffle maker, you can buy it with the exposure the idols pay you in. Don't expect us to chip in.
I've told you before, the idols are trying to build a post-capitalist society where money is not a concept.
Yeah?
You know what? This actually has potential. He's being taken advantage of by some people who are like, yeah, dude, you shouldn't worry about money, right? And that could be like a moment, right?
Then why don't you go run off and join the commune?
I'm into showering. Are you gonna help me get the waffle maker or not?
You know what? Actually, based.
As an investor, I don't like wasting money.
You're wearing a fucking bow tie.
Okay. I will...
Nice, actually.
Throw in 20 bucks for a waffle maker.
Nina?
Good for 10.
You know what? I already like the cheaty knockoff.
Your forged paintings last month.
Fine, 15.
What sort of waffle maker can I get for 35 bucks?
Bro. If you go to Goodwill, they have waffle makers that are practically new for like $16. At most, like, 25. Go to a fucking thrift store, you piece of shit. Are you serious right now? Are you serious right now?
Presumably one that makes fucking waffles?
Hey! Hey! The wage slave is back!
How was your- Fucking waffles?
Hey! Hey! The wage slave is back!
Stop it! You were the chosen one! You were the chosen one, Genie!
How was your first day? Were the other mercenaries nice to you?
Oh my
god. Now, as far as hired killers go, I'd give them a 7.
You look like you could use a mimosa.
Thanks, Eli. Seriously. How's the job? It's the murder business. The fundamentals don't change, just the uniform.
I can tell you love it.
Okay. I don't have to love it, I have to pay my student loans.
Poof. I'm in.
So I'm... guessing that means the pay's good.
It's supposed to be. Got stiffed on my bonus today.
Dude, what the fuck?
I played a little fast...
He's wearing a fucking fanny pack.
Fast and loose on the job, and, well, my CEO wasn't a fan.
You gotta be kidding me.
Swear to God, this lady walked right off the set of an 80s
action. Is this character modeled off Sniper Wolf? Chat, I just fucking realized, did the fucking... Chat, Eli is just literally cheaty? She should sue. Bro, it's literally Sniper Wolf. It's literally Sniper... What?
I wasn't a fan.
You gotta be kidding me.
Bro! Well, now she has bangs, right? But like, how she used to look... Yeah, like this, right?
friends, it's me. Your favorite blueberry snack. There's a lot of things I-
It's Sniper Wolf. What the fuck?
I want in my house. Cotton candy machine. A popcorn machine. A water slide. A roller coaster. I don't even know what these are called. Cushions. It's-
Same girl, huh?
Swear to God, this lady walked right off the set of an 80s action movie. I was half expecting her to call me Rook and threaten to take my badge.
Are we gonna make rent?
We'll make rent. We just gotta be a little more creative.
Last time we got creative, I got stabbed 3 times.
Roller glasses equals sniper. Fucking look at her, dude!
It would've been 4 times if Nina and I hadn't shown up.
It would've been 0 times if you were on time.
This is true. Look, this is really not a big deal. We just knock off a payday loan place. No one gives a shit
if- Diet Snipple. Spray is in your pee.
People rob those bastards.
Oh, Captain Thunderbolt, Ingrid 140, shirtless guy is Hassan Piker.
You have a job.
He doesn't look like Hassan though, really, does he?
Eli, I don't do business with morally bankrupt companies.
You work for Marshall.
Brunch is-
Also, he's not like on the grift, right? Like, that's the thing with like Hassan, right? Is Hassan like- Like, talks about these things, but doesn't actually, like, participate in them. Whereas this guy is actually, like, being a bum. Right? Like, Hassan has, like, a fucking multi-million dollar mansion, right? This guy is not on the grind set like that.
Mimosas, not debates on morality.
Alright, alright.
Man, this is really fucking good, Kev.
Thanks. I was worried I added too much pepper.
No, seriously, this is perfect. The only way this could be better is if you put on a fucking shirt.
Dinner and a show, baby.
Oh, please.
I'm gonna fucking...
Kill yourself.
Oh my god.
Okay, brunch is done, dishes are clean. Let's go rob a payday loan place.
And you know how we should celebrate afterwards.
Karaoke!
Holy shit.
Yes!
Holy shit, chat.
So, Nina. Are we taking your project car?
Why is there no music? Why is there no fucking music in this game, Jack?
I'm not risking my baby over rent. We're boosting cars.
Are you guys noticing this shit? There is no fucking BGM at all.
Can we take a hybrid?
Eli, I love that you're worried about fuel efficiency, but I'm thinking acceleration.
Holy shit!
Your carbon footprint already.
Probably to avoid DMCA. DMCA? Is there a version of this that does have, like, music? Maybe- hold on. I'm gonna click through a playthrough and see if somebody has, like, Help me to tab.
I mean, I think they robbed this guy too close to home.
No music here? No music here?
Oh, of course they caught us up.
No music here?
I think what this game needs is a
no music here? Oh my god, I used to watch the Rad Brad before PewDiePie took off. Before like PewDiePie and Markiplier and all that shit, right? Which I do watch those guys now. I used to watch the Rad Brad and one time I heard a kid talking about him at school and I was like, holy shit. People watch Let's Players? Holy shit! And I was like, oh my god. It was a moment.
It says kick. You want me to kick this thing?
Oh!
All right,
oh, there's
right
music here!
Jesus Christ!
You're not gonna last.
Your pep talks need some work.
No music this there!
What about the aiming? It's like all...
Oh, music here!
Now we're just flying around. Love it.
No music here.
Oh, hold on. Here we go.
Music here? No. Oh, more music?
Hold on.
More music? More music?
Stay here.
No music. Okay. Did they forget? Did they just forget? Did they fucking forget that?
space matters.
Just take that.
What the hell? Yeah, looks like it's not DMCA. It's not DMCA. They just fucking forgot to put music in some parts of the game, I guess. Holy shit, dude.
Kev, you
can't. And it's not even just like, oh, the cutscenes don't have music, but the missions do, right? Because there were some of these... There were some of the things that I just showed you, right? Where the cutscenes did have music. Some of the missions had music, and then some of the missions had no music. And some of the cutscenes had no music. So what the fuck?
It's the place? What are we looking
what
at?
What the fuck?
One guard out front, and the owner at the till.
Look up the OST? Scuzzbag. Is it even uploaded? Oh, 46 videos? Oh! So there actually is, like, music in the game. They just... use it very sparingly, I guess? Show the cutscene, stop listening to chat! Aye!
I want some kick of dog.
Not every scene has to have music in it. No. Not every scene has to have music in it. But music does add a lot. Music adds a lot. When you take away music, you're like making a statement in something, right? When you just have your game randomly not have music in it, right? Like that skydiving mission that I showed earlier.
Almost there. Let's get psyched.
Why would that not have music?
Crap again.
Hey, what's the rule?
Don't yuck someone's yum.
That life throws your way.
You have I'm...
That's right. Be your own boss.
Join my MLM today.
To listen to music in the car.
Roger McGillicuddy speaks the music of my soul.
You are.
Oh, there we go. There we go. It's explained.
Are a different kind of caddy.
They're speaking music to us, Kent.
The world is full of uninteresting people, and I'm not gonna be one of them. You got one?
I have bad news.
One of those for me?
You really want one after last time?
I am not the first person to accidentally shoot a friend by dropping a loaded... Yeah, okay, I don't need a gun.
Good call. Showtime.
Okay. Jesus Christ. It's so fucking awkward, Chad. It's so fucking awkward! It should have music! Do not tell me that this should not have music on it!
Shit.
Walk away, or the phrase dead-end job gets literal.
Holy shit. Literally, these aren't real people.
We don't want your money. Well, yes, no,
literally,
they're
not.
Get out of here.
You done fucked up.
I've been getting that a lot lately. Where's a safe?
If you're lucky, the cops will get to you before my people.
Nice left.
Oh my god, did they just assault somebody for protecting his business?
Practicing.
I can tell.
Not even mask? Nope.
Safe's back here.
Wow.
This guy had his password be a bunch of fives.
Pick it up, Eli.
I'm just saying, he could have at least made his work for it.
This is insufferable. Holy shit.
Same plan as last time. Eli, Kev,
no mask, no gloves.
Matter and get the money home. Nina and I will split up and give the cops a run around.
Cool.
Hey, Nina, thank you for the $5. Well, now look up the budget of the screen first and just tell me. Tell me, chat, how much did this game cost to make? I don't know what like a good amount is for a game.
See you with the Switch.
Firelight Armor Reviews, thank you for the $10. This is the triple A soy boy version of Star Fetchers. Basically Fight Club, but starring who Big Red thinks he is. Chat, you're just guessing! You're just guessing, chat! And now I think we're the 172. Check out the Saints Row 2 court scene to compare. Okay, you guys keep bringing that up. Saints Row 2 court scene. If this sucks, I'm gonna beat your ass, chat.
You've been convicted of over 300 murders. Do you really expect this appeal to work?
I figure.
Well, it works for politicians. Is there, like, context to this? I feel like this is a bit short.
This one? A notorious member of a gang once known as the Third Street Saints.
I'm not this too long.
Was arrested last year in an assassination attempt against then-decorated police officer Troy
this
Bradshaw.
One?
In the resulting trial, Jack was convicted of one count of attempted murder.
Yeah,
and
this
staggering
has ambient music, right? This is the environmental music.
Hey, Barry, turn this shit off.
Yeah, I was watching that.
I guess you're not anymore.
What happens after the first game? Oh, this isn't the trial, but this is the context. Oh. Okay, well, we can skip ahead a little bit. The fucking run animation is so dorky, what the hell?
Mr. Gat, you've been convicted of over 300 murders. Do you really expect this appeal to work?
I figure with the statute of limitations, it really should be closer to 250.
There's no statute of limitations for murder!
Why the fuck not?
Watch yourself, Mr. Gat.
Or what? You hold me in contempt of court? You're already planning on giving me the chair. You think I'd give a shit about you not liking me? Fuck off.
I'm curious if you can keep your cavalier attitude when 2,000 volts are running through your body.
Oh yeah? And I'm curious if you can keep acting like a douchebag when I shove that gavel up your ass.
My client would like that stricken from the record.
What's that?
Oh my god, chat.
Drop it.
An actually fun cutscene, chat. An actually amusing cutscene. I don't know if that joke about the gavel really landed, but...
Anyone hit and need a lawyer?
Shit. About time your burnt ass woke up.
You okay, Johnny?
Yeah, aside from almost getting sent to the chair, I'm fucking great. Hey, you look different. You do something with your hair?
You ready to get out of here?
Wow, chat, an actually fucking fun moment. An actually fun moment. The fucking audio performed by people that actually cared about what the fuck they were saying. Holy shit. Wow. Interesting characters. The fucking lack of music is not fucking deafening. Jesus Christ.
Adversity and challenges.
Maybe that's the problem. Maybe these cutscenes don't need music, but the fact that there is no fucking music and the fact that, like, everything is so stilted and awkward makes it deafening.
I'm monitoring the police scanner. They're just responding to the call.
It's just so fucking, like...
Cops are now en route to the payday place. Sounds like...
Did somebody say it's barely different? Oh, fuck off. Oh, fuck off. Police en route too? It's just so boring. Excuse me? Excuse me?
You called for a ride.
What?
You said you didn't want to risk your car. I said I didn't want to risk it.
What?
I'd risk anything for you, dummies.
Okay. Spider car.
So, is this how it's gonna be every time?
Was that a G-Bot video?
I thought that went great. Yeah, okay.
This whole game is just G-Bot.
Go back to running my old side hustle.
Fox Bunch.
Don't
Holy
worry.
Shit.
We'll figure it out. This town is full of opportunities.
Poor owns a classic car. If don't ask questions. God.
Hey.
Don't insult G-Mod. I'm sorry.
We have to get better at this.
It tried to be
thing,
DMC. DMC 5 and failed.
Also, we'll get evicted.
Duel in the Dark thing. There's something missing with that action outside. Sequence. I would love, like, an actual fucking animator, right? To come in. And break down why these fucking scenes are so just lifeless. Why they just don't fucking hit right, chat. They just fucking don't.
Side hustles. I have some friends who might need work.
Why these sins?
Area of expertise.
When you say friends, do you mean friends or special friends?
All my friends are special. I'll put their info on your map.
I don't get it.
I think you really like them.
I like them fine as long as their money's good.
Thanks, Kev.
Why am I seeing gunfire at the back of that convoy?
Gwen? Well, there were motorcycles and then a turret, and one thing led to another.
Well, that was cool.
You don't sound
I mean,
that.
this scene looks like it could be fun.
One car after a convoy
it just, if everything feels so fucking awkward, chat. Everything feels so fucking awkward. Each scene is too long. They should do jump cuts or something. I don't know, man. I don't fucking know. Like, I don't...
Well... Looks
wow,
like
this place is fucking huge.
Over. Yeah. No work today?
I'm leaving Sergio's group text on red.
Fair.
Los Panteros have been going downhill since he started leading.
I don't...
It used to be about family.
Boring mope scene?
Now it's all about him.
It's lack of eye cake, inertia, and not pacing dialogue to the camera angle?
I want to eat my feelings.
Bitch, shut the fuck up! Oh my god. Froggy, thank you for the $10. You should watch the Saints Row 2 cutscene where Gat buries the Ronin leader. Danny D, thank you for the $1.99 budget was a little over 30 million? Waffles, lol, random. All they have is a waffle and a fucking bottle of alcohol. Oh! Ah, this is the scene! Oh, I guess it was just an issue on his end.
Come the fuck on. God damn.
Plug it in, motherfucker.
Damn it.
It's not plugged in. It's not plugged in!
Stupid refurbished appliances.
I'm gonna fucking lose it.
Figures?
I'm gonna fucking lose it, chat. That was so fucking cringe. That was so fucking cringe, chat. What the fuck even was that? What the fuck even was that, chat? Holy shit.
The premier auction experience for knife connoisseurs of all ages. Our first stop...
Stupid refurbished appliances. What? Shut the fuck up, though. I just...
Temporary update
yeah,
on
poor her in her refurbished appliances. Oh no.
The lung piercer.
Motherfucker, at least it's fucking refurbished, right? That means somebody fucking worked on it. Why are you mad? That's a step up. That's a fucking step up. You could just buy it secondhand and you don't know what the fuck is wrong with it, if anything is. Chill the fuck out, bitch.
Santa Waliso that knows their stabbing implements. Let's bring out the next item.
God.
It's been a hell of a day.
It uses Bluetooth. Oh, yeah.
I've been saving the
I forgot. Game was made in Silicon Valley. All those motherfuckers, they have like the fucking like Juicero and shit. Yeah, refurbished means it's fixed. Like, what the fuck?
Last. The Judas 3000. If Brutus had had one of these bad boys, he wouldn't have needed the Senate to help stab Caesar.
Get it!
How many knives did you end up buying? Not enough.
Hey, Sergio just texted us.
He has to be pretty pissed.
Yeah. Says he's planning on attacking the Idols party.
Man, I'd hate to be the Idols right now. Everyone at that party is probably gonna get killed.
Sucks to be Kevin.
Pippa, are you in pain right now? I don't know what the fuck I'm feeling.
Oh, shit. We gotta go.
They're not coming, are they?
They'll get over it, man. Don't worry about it.
Chat, I don't know what the fuck I'm watching.
They're totally pissed at me.
We're poor! She fucking just bought a bunch of knives.
They'll get over it.
What?
Give them time. You mind if I get a drink?
You do you, man.
Can I have a white wine spritzer?
You know what? That was actually pretty good. That wasn't, like, top quality. But that was actually a decent scene. That actually... had pretty decent pacing. Chat, my standards... are so fucking low. That was enough, chat. That was something. That was something. Impact. Yeah, there was some impact.
Eli.
Holy shit, I wish you had been burned. I don't know.
Are you okay?
Oh yeah, it does have music. So. This scene has music. What the fuck?
Get in and drive fast.
QB is Rage Zanger with a 199. All dialogue is either snarky quip or exposition. John Day Zanger, $10. Comedy writers that take themselves seriously over
try to get a hold
dramatic
of
writers that refuse to deliver their stories without 10 layers of irony.
Nothing. Oh, you?
No.
Troll. No. Monkey Zanger with a 199. The Ram Gaming with a $2. Look up Saints Row 3. Professor Genki trailer.
He'll never listen.
It's worth a try.
Why are you running towards gunfire? Don't ask questions. The idea of wallowing in your sadness joke is a pretty good concept. Could have been good. The first mission of Saints Row 4 is... First mission of Saints Row 4 kind of thing, but it's just boring here. No over-the-top animation or anything. What the fuck? What about getting late? It is getting late. I should wrap it up. I got caught up in the cringe.
My friends are in there.
I got caught up in the fucking cringe, chat.
You are taking Los Panteros to war just because you think Marshall and the idols...
Thank you, guys. Well, for popping in. It's been good, cringe, man.
Call it off or I quit.
You ain't gonna quit.
Try me.
Is this good, cringe? I feel my fucking soul dying. I'm just glad that this game isn't, like, popular for some reason, right? Like, The Last of Us 2, when that shit was, like,
He's
popping
calling.
Off.
Calling. Put it on speaker.
And the whole time, right? I just...
I'm fine, but Eli...
You fucking shot me!
You're doing great, Eli. Stay cool.
I mean, that was kind of a funny voice line. Like, at least this is, like, irrelevant, right? At least this is irrelevant. I don't have quite as much seething, because it's like... It's not like the fucking The Last of Us 2, where it felt like it was so obviously bad, and everyone was, like, acting like it was good, and you were dumb for thinking it was bad. That was, like, some fucking The Emperor's New Clothes shit. At least this is fucking irrelevant, and everybody knows it. Go in the dark, thank you for $5. Complains about capitalism, constantly buys random stuff, hipster brand, or expensive stuff for show. I don't know, man. I think you can have, like, a critique of systems while still participating in them. But I also think that character buying a bunch of knives when she can't afford rent, like... When they can't afford, like, their fucking waffle maker or whatever. I don't know, man. Participating versus luxury? Yeah. I don't know. It's easy to avoid being gaslit once you understand that everyone else is an idiot and therefore wrong. This game is turning me into an angry old man that hates young people. This isn't young people. This is, like... I mean, they're young, but, like... This is, like, millennials. So, I don't know, man. We got more here. I think we're becoming a big PP. God, this was fucking terrible, chat. This is literally Zoomers? No, they're millennials. The whole thing is millennials.
Eli's behind the bar. I'm keeping him covered.
Nina and I are on our way.
It's caked in, like, a layer of Zoomer aesthetics with some things, right? Like the Dead Mouse helmets and shit, but...
And that means we're gonna need both hands, okay?
This game was made by millennials.
I promise.
Well, this is Zoomers written by millennials?
Shit, the Panteros group chat is blowing.
You know what, Chad? I don't know what the fuck it is, but I fucking hate it. There you go. It's fucking Silicon Valley and Instagram, and I fucking hate it. I don't know what fucking, like, generation this shit is. But it's Silicon Valley meets Instagram, and I fucking hate it. Yeah. So, thank you for stopping by. My name is Pipkin Pippa. I appreciate you stopping in. I'll be streaming tomorrow again at the same time as today. Oh my god. 9 p.m. ET, 6 p.m. BT. What the heck? The Bram Gaming League with $2. Saints Row ain't straight up bussing for real, no cap. Sheesh. Thank you. I just lost a couple years off my life for that. Was it Saints Row 3 Genki? This? Genki trailer? Is this one? We'll watch one last thing. We'll end on hopefully a high note. Holy shit, epilepsy warning. Holy fuck. Holy fuck, epilepsy warning clip. Holy fuck, click off now.
Professor Genki! Arrives Hyper Ordinary Pre-Order Pack, featuring splendid devices for maximum pleasure in urban combat. The Super Ballistic Manapult! Powerfully incapacitating octopus guns! And sleek, fashionable stun suit! Prepared ultra tight! Superior pre-order event pre-arranged by generous genius Professor Genki begins now!
What the fuck am I watching?
Show the acquisition of yours today!
Oh fuck! I don't know how I feel about that one, Chad. I don't know how I feel about that one, man. I don't know how I feel about that one, man. Yeah, this was too far for me. Yeah, that one was a little bit too far for me. I don't know about that one, man. But yeah, that could have stayed in 2011. Oh my god. Anime document, thank you for the $2. Zoom, zoom! Zoomy, zoom! Zoomer! Weekend Warrior, thank you for the 1803. It's supposed to be a gritty mercenary struggling for rent, a bunch of kids. The turn to crime, but is tainted with the oh-whoa quirky writing. These things just clash with each other, and the writers can't clearly balance it. Wow. Yeah, no, they cannot. No, they cannot at all. That is your ancestor! Show some respect! I'm sorry, Bobby! Jesus! I'm sorry! God damn! You guys are dorks. Alright, I'm gonna read off names from chat. All you have to do to have your name read... Oh, there's so fucking many people here. Jesus Christ. All you have to do to have your name read is to type in chat. Oh, fuck my crap! Sorry. All you have to do to have your name read is, type in chat every 2 minutes. I read the names off alphabetically. If I miss your name, I'm sorry. Sometimes I miss names. I really fucking hope all 1,100 of you do not fucking try to get your name read. Holy shit. I'm gonna do it. Yeah, every 2 minutes. Susan boots you from the participants list if you don't type in chat, like, every 2 minutes. I don't know why it works that way. It's fucking stupid. It's so fucking stupid. Susan is fucking dumb. But hey, at least we're not on Twitch. At least we're not on Twitch, baby! should I start from top to bottom? Maybe? I don't know. Should I, like, get some, like... We'll leave some, like, footage playing, I guess. Did I click off the thing? I guess I clicked off the cutscenes. Here we go. I'll leave some cutscenes playing. And you can just enjoy the cringe while I read off the names. Oh, yeah, thank you for being a big day! Alright, thank you so much for stopping by! Redactado. Aaron Kelly, Aaron Sutton, Actual Prisoner, Adele Darkstar, Aegis, Andre Vasquez, Anime Document, Inertian, Anon, Anubis Mage, Archive Bro, Archivisama, Archon of Plagues, Arid, Armless Kirby, RV, Ascended Weeb, Atomic Steam Engine, A Wild Weeb, Elamel, EZ, As the Thoth, Bad Engineering, Badger Cape, Bahamut, Banana Cup, Banana Hoarder, Bash the Azure Dragoon, BQ, Belmont Rose, Berserk Rage, Big Bubba Gordo, Big Fuzzy Hat, Big Guy, Bilbo Swaggins, Billy Watch Doctor, BJ Munch, Bleach, Blau, Bloody Overdrive, Bloshi, Blue Spirit, Montide, Box, Brandon, Brian Lane, Brylington, Budetto, C14 Dog. Ew, you have that fucking metaverse fucking influencer bitch as your profile picture. Jesus Christ. Off-brand Miku. Captain Fields, Carl, Cassidel Bowen, Cassidy, Caddis Fine 2, CGXJP95, Charles August, Charlie, Chris Belair, Christopher Ortez, Cosmic, thank you for going a big peep peep blah, blah, blah. Lots of cringe, lots of cringe! This is so many names. Church Cheetah, Chuba, Enjoyer, Christopher Ortez, Cypher, Coconut Tackle, Cody, Cody Katana, Color Me Blue, Conquer the Kid, Corpus Insanus, Crocodilinae, Crossbomb Vanguard, Cybornack, D19, Dagoon Man, Dai Hachi Hachi, Dalai Lama, Dance Grub, Danny, D, Darsoup, David Bonwick, David Gonzalez, Dave DeVito, Dead Mac Gaming, D's Nutter, Demono, Denied, Dolores, Double Hitman, Deox, or Dexie Channel, Diego Quayler, Dyed Water, thank you, Salami, for becoming a big peepee, Jill Fan, Doberoo, Donald, Doomsday Dan, Dr. Decaf, Duck Dick, Duke Conrad, Easy, Acne, Ether, Ed, or ED Mon 7, Egotistic Killers, Iber, Emmanuel Castellanos, Amne I Say, End War, Endymion, Enzella, Enzo, Eric Moore, Eric Villarreal, Ethel, Expletive Deleted, Fate Exchanger, Father Delta, SC Playthroughs, Fine Chap, Gaz, Frank Reno, Freeze, Fresno, Frost, Frugal Joker, Fakuneko, Fumetsu Kage, Gmo, Gabri, Gabriel Navarro, Ghastly Guest, Goshog, Giga Demon, TK Lore, Goblin Slayer, Google Plus Sucks Balls, Guanaco, Gundam Forever, Gun, Ha 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 Ha, Handsome Mork. Thank you, The Night, for becoming a big peepee. Wow, 3 months. Hopefully someone gives me the fourth month for free. Lamau. Hank, Harbinger, Haxars, Ponchi, Hayabusa, Hikikomori Charlie, Hikikimoto, or Hikimoto, Hero Alchemy, Hiljep, Hunk Des, Heezy Lung, I'm Jack, Suffocating Nihilism, I Live Again, Infinite Raid, Irving B, Isaac, Jade, JM, Jello Shot, Jackass, Jackie, Jaxter, Jackass, Jacob, Pollock, James, James Harbour, James Jameson, Jason Long, Jazine Harrell, JD Cohen, Jefferson Oliver, Jelly, Jimmy Inc., Jinx, Dale710, Joe Mom Joe, Joe Schmo, John Garrison, John Ross Jones, John Zero, Jojo Royce, Joseph Wild, Junior Autumn, Julian, Canary, Kyle. Oh, thank you, Dolores, for the 5 kippies! Thank you! Kane, Karikora, Katrina the Insane, Kachek, Oxar, Kevin, Killer King, King Crab Cakes, King Phantom, King Godzilla, Ken Patsu, Kizna Hentai Clean, Nai, Korgoth, Kozlewick, Case the Royal Cuddly Kitty Cat, Kurisu, Kuwata, Kylie, Lana, Nielsen, Lancer, Late, Laughing Man, D8D, La Monkey, Leonardo Aloha, Low Gremlin, Lime Green Joint, Lion MX, Logan, Loner, Lonnie, McLovin, Loose Chains, Lord Sharam, Lore Spade, Loud Shark, Luca, Lupus, Ebrius, Lyrical Jesus, Lavender, Magmag, Magapaddle, Main Battle Tanks, Mal Roadkill, Amantonius, oh god, the names are disappearing, Mantarok, Marcus Sharka, Marcus Minicus, Marcus Lazy, Mark Knife, Mason R, Master Hellion, Mateza, Matthew McKellar, Mauricio, Mick, M. Carpenter, Methy, Merciful Scotch, Metal Mint, Manus, Next Euphemism, Midori Dorky, Mr. Yura, Mr. Chewy, Mitchell Stewart, Mitchell Bader, Morty, Moto, Mr. Zolo, Mr. Hill, Mr. U Jellyfish. That's a good name. I like your avatar too. It's a little Sylveon. Mumber Thrax, Munch, Mustafa, Nobody, and 333, Nama Kimono, Nana, Never Fail, Nico Maureen, Night Vision, Nilfi, Nira Ori, Nobody, No More, Noble Narwhal, Nobody, North Carolina Ball, Not One of Us, Notes, Not Even Real, Nyohado, Nyohado, Odwin, Optimal, Orange Crowbar Man, Ozone, Panic Panic, Partially Impartial, Patriot USA, Pelbo, Pepe, A la Squid, Perokami, Peter Okik, Lost, Petra Lover, I'm laughing about the fucking Pepe, man. It's a fucking Squidward, there's a Pepe. Pataku, Billy, Pippa's Nippa, Pippa's Not Eating Vegetables, Pixel Rush, Boop Meat, Frog Champ, Psyop Cyclops, Killin, Crystal Orange Juice, Rocket the Mario, Ragafurio, Rando, Rathman, Razlo, Razmaz, Red Remover, Red Shipley, Renegan, Renatus Lupus, Retrograde Rustic, Rexarada, Richard Returns, Rich Troxling, Rob H, Raffle Chief, Romulus, Roscoe, Ruler Lenner, Rush, Rusty Row, Rysko, Ryan, Ryuka, Salamandra, Salami, Sandwicho, Sarah J. Jacobson, Sasak Puppet, Skills Tipper, SES, Scud, Sean Huang, Sebastian Sebes, Secret Seeker, Setsuna Konoe, Shadowface, Shiro Magane, Sigma Zero, Soliamara, Skidheim, Skike, Slip McDrip, Slifer Gospel, oh god, the names. Smoke Weeb Every Day, Soulfrax, Some Weird Guy, Small, Some Polygon, Sonic Ticker, Soraxis, Dragular, Tussle Go, Sparrow, Spider Dude, Spoon, Spud Sprout, Spurious, Steven, Stone Turtle, Strawberry Pillow, Sunbro, Swagmaster, T90M, T3 Denix, Tamago, Tamamo Respector, Tangerines, Tangerines and Tangent, I get it. Dow Twist, Tash Kent, oh, one of my favorite chips in, well, I think you have Can Cole as your avatar, but I like Tashkent and Azure Lane. Tawoli, Talos! Petrimo, Texas Toast, That Video Game Felt, The Goth King, The Justin One, The King of Toasters, The Private The Sword Art Online... The Sword Art Online Decorating Association, the Big Sweet, the Cold 2T, the Cyber Police, the Internet Man, the King of Hopeless, the Minecraft Reloaded, Tiberium Gaming, Toasty Boy, Tokyo Cowboy, Tomato Houses, Topaz, Trigger Point, Travis Touchdown, Trellis, Turbo, Twizmire, Tycho, Tyler, Zoide Speaks, Zunami, Uncle Sam, Undead Wolf, Undercover Lolicon, Unintentionally Dramatic, Earth, Valiant, AVR, Veldrin, Vic Viper, Vash... Did I say Vash already? Vic Viper, Vice, Urban Aristocrat, Welcome to Die, Well Played, Wee Major, White Man, Wick the Bird, Winchester Locke, Windsor, Wolfgang Krauser, Woma, Woodsman, Ray Day, Zenlar, Shoram, XX, KCIN, XX, Zingro, XYZ, Y2N, Yahtzee, Yoshi, Itaru, You Are Like Cinnamon, Your Friend, Z Black, Zuhart, JE, and Chen. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. I really appreciate it, and I will see you guys tomorrow! I'm sorry if I missed your name! Oh, you said Bash at the start. Oh, my bad. Okay, good night! Japanese name I cannot pronounce. No, there's no Japanese name. You forgot Aegis. Aegis! She said my name. Time to GSE. No! It bang! Oh, good night. Raffle Chief, did I say your name? Oh, the Overdrive, Magmag, the Fine Chap, Gaz, DJ Munch, Kalau, Moto, Hori, Yahtzee, Kenpatsu, Eric Rowdy, John, Zapata. There's a lot of names, I'm sorry. I'm sorry if I missed anyone. Mitsuhashi Takashi. Loading, Please Wait. Logan. Hiddly Kitty Cat. Bilbo Swaggins. A lot of names. I don't think the participants list actually showed it. That was like 5 minutes of reading names. Jesus. Oh, did you miss me? MJC? Did I even see that? I don't know. As you play this thing with the tutorials, you missed a few? Better start over now! Good night! Karaoke scream. Okay, now if you like bad karaoke, you need to click off. Oh, by the way, don't forget to subscribe. I always forget. I had so many viewers and I should have said, oh, by the way, please subscribe. I forgot. Oh well, subscriber count means nothing anyways. Karaoke scream. Fail. Hashtag fail. Hashtag. Totally ditzy, Lamau. I'm so dumb. 50k? Did I hit 50k? Hold on, let me refresh. I did not hit 50k. God damn it! 900 to 50k, chat! Listen, I don't normally ask for shilling, but you know, I'm very close to 50k. If you want to shill me, just to give me the 50k. Alright, listen, I'm really fucking close! I'm really fucking close, chat! Sing power? Yeah, let's do power. Power. Kanye West. Karaoke. Hell yeah. Let's go. I'm living in that 21st century. Doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Scream from the haters, got a nice ring to it. Guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man to have all that power. Clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. 21st century, schizoid rabbit. System broken, the school's closed, the prison's open. We ain't got nothing to lose, motherfucker, we rolling. Huh? Motherfucker, we rolling. Some light-skinned girls and some Kelly Rollins. In this white man world, we the chosen ones. Oh, it's good night, cruel world. I'll see you in the morning. Huh? I'll see you in the morning. This is way too much, I need a moment. No one man should have all that power. Clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. Till then, fuck that, the world's ours. And they say, 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 century schizoid, pippa! Fuck SNL and the whole cast. Tell them Yeezy said they can kiss my whole ass. More specifically, they can kiss my asshole. I'm an asshole, you got jokes, you short-minded. That is Napoleon. My fur's Mongolian. My eyes are brought to the goalies. And I embody every characteristic of the egotistic. He knows he's so fucking gifted. I just need a time alone with my own thoughts. I was like, I got treasures in my mind, but couldn't open my own vault. My childlike creativity, purity, and honesty is honestly being crowded by these grown thoughts. Reality's catching up with me, taking my inner child. I'm fighting for custody with these responsibilities that they entrusted me. As I look down at my diamond encrusted keys, thinking no one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. So I'm tripping off the powder. Villain, fuck that, the world's ours. And they say, stay with that. And they say, Sentry, Schizoid, Chad, Colin Powell, Austin Powers. Lost in translation with the whole fucking nation. They say I was an abomination of Obama's nation. Well, that's a pretty bad way to start the conversation. At the end of the day, goddammit, I'm killing this shit. I know damn well y'all feeling this shit. I don't need your pussy, bitch, I'm on my own dick. I ain't kinda foul, Jim, who you going home with? How you doing? I'm surviving. I was drinking earlier, now I'm driving. Where the bad bitches, huh? Where you hiding? I got the power to make your life so exciting. Are you singing along, chat? I don't know how this goes. Hey, da 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 da. Now this will be a beautiful death. I'm jumping out the window. I'm letting everything go. I'm letting everything go. Now this will be a beautiful death. I'm jumping out the window. I'm letting everything go. I'm letting everything go. Now this will be a beautiful death. I'm jumping out the window. I'm letting everything go. Letting everything go. You got the power to let power go. Thank you for trying, you're welcome. Thank you for putting up with me, chat. Hell yeah! Fight the power, chat! Okay, who do I raid in though? Sentry, Schizoid, chat. You guys are a bunch of geebers. Good night, I hope you sleep well, motherfucker. Is nobody live right now? I wanna raid into somebody, but there's nobody live. Why does my reverb sound weird? Oh, cause I changed my settings. Is nobody live? What the fuck? Oh, is she not live? Hold on. She's not coming up on my thing. Are you sure? Hold on, let me go to the Face Connect website. She's not popping up in my thing! Time to take meds! What the heck? She is live! What the fuck? Why is she not popping up?
Because the default colors is blend.
Okay. Maybe if I paste it? There we go. Yeah, I had to manually enter the URL.